show me the news.
And now, coming through your speakers and into your ears, it's the gaming podcast that you all know and love. It's Show Me Your News.
Your favorite Super Smash Bros. Brawl podcast from 2007 continues to cover the latest in the video game industry at showmeyournews.com. Now, let's join the show.
Welcome!
Welcome to Show Me Your News,
the pinnacle for delivering and debating the gaming news that matters the most to you.
Rumor-filled gossip, hardware blunders, or upcoming releases.
If it relates to video games, we want to talk about it.
I am Peter, but you may know me as Youko, and I am so excited to watch E3 on the big screen.
I am Rachel, but you may know me as Eevee, and I don't get to watch it because I'm stuck at work.
I'm Joe, but you may know me as the thedobaga, and I only took off Sony and Nintendo's days.
I'm Ben, but you may know me as GymleaderBen, and I'm double-fisting Boddington's pub ale.
What?!
Aw, yeah. It's that pre-E3 podcast here on Show Me Your News. We're part of the SMYN network at showmeyournews.com, and today is Saturday, June 6th, 2015. Episode 181 of the podcast. It's the E3 call-in show. We have Sword Hunter acting as moderator.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Mark.
So we get to have some people this year to join us on the podcast, and we're going to be answering our 50 E3 yes or no questions. So that should be a lot of fun.
Yes, we have 9 people lined up, 2 per topic, and 1 so far for the reveal questions. Mm-hmm. So we're hoping this goes pretty smoothly.
I'm really looking forward to seeing what predictions come out of this.
Absolutely, because after each person's stint, we have the Big Boss and the Kiefer predictions. Now, the Big Boss they're bold predictions. I mean, reasonable, but they take a little bit of cojones to predict. And the Kiefer prediction, it's like having Kiefer Sutherland in Metal Gear Solid 5. It's just balls to the wall crazy. It's madness.
So are you saying that I can't make either one because I don't have balls?
You got them balls to make them predictions. So
okay.
We'll be just fine. So let's start with our first guest. So please welcome to the podcast. It's DQP.
Hello, hello. How you
hello.
Doing?
Hey, so you are the host of Refrigerated Reviews.
Indeed.
So you've come to this podcast to help answer some of these yes or no questions and give your predictions. I'm happy to have you.
All right, I'm happy to be here.
So I want to start with Microsoft first. We have 10 questions, and I think we'll have you here for 5 of them. Let's start with the first one. Will Halo 5 Guardians open or close the show?
I personally don't think so, because the thing with Microsoft is that they always open with Call of Duty. I think that's a given. Most of the time anyway. And they always close with some really big, awesome surprise that we don't know about yet. So I think Halo 5 Guardians is going to find itself somewhere in the middle of that.
I'm kind of surprised because I would have said that because of people being so much more hyped for, like, you know, Halo 5 and all these trailers that have been coming out as well and people wanting to know more about what's going on, I would imagine that they would have put that either at the beginning or at the end. I would have said more at the end. Really
interesting.
As again, like, you say that there's surprises at the end, and I agree with that, but you know, the fact that we really don't know a lot about what's going on with this new Halo, that could be our surprise.
Possible. I mean, last year they had the Master Chief Collection kind of right in the middle, and it was an interesting thing that they did last year with their conference where they put all the 2014 games first, and then it's like, well, here's all the future games in the second half of the show. And because, like, Master Chief Collection was their big one for last year, they put it kind of right in the middle at the end of that first half. So it's going to be another thing altogether whether or not, you know, the launch of Halo 5 Guardians goes like how Master Chief Collection did. But I'm going to actually question one of the things you said here. You said how, you know, usually Call of Duty opens the show, and it's been that way for a long time. There are rumors in the industry that I think Activision is jumping ship with Call of Duty to PlayStation this year. And that would be certainly interesting because, yeah, it has been a kind of thing for a while that, you know, it's Microsoft and it's Activision for Call of Duty because Xbox 360 was the leader and a lot of those big third parties like to kind of follow the leader, as it were. I'm not sure that it's going to be Black Ops 3 opening the show or even having a presence at all at Microsoft. So I said that it's not going to be Halo 5 opening or closing the show. I think it's going to be kind of somewhere in the middle. And it's going to take a big part of the show, but not necessarily a one more thing sort of deal at the end, but not a let's open big either.
Right. And I don't know about Call of Duty jumping shit, because you look at recent sales, Xbox One's actually been doing pretty all right recently.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't know.
It is interesting to note, though, that when Black Ops 3 was revealed with that trailer, and you had all the journalists who got to see a little preview of it before that, so they could get their stories ready, all of those games were running on PlayStation 4 in this little room that, you know, you had pictures taken of. So maybe that's just because it performs best on PlayStation 4. I don't know if that's a telltale sign at all. I mean, it'd be interesting to see what happens with that.
And that's something interesting that I've noticed going into E3 as a whole, is that you look at a lot of announcement trailers for a lot of games earlier this year. They're all running on PS4.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Battlefront reveal, that was on PlayStation's channel, I think. And so was Mankind Divided. So you make a good point. Call of Duty could jump ship, but at the same time, they've always kind of been with Microsoft, and Microsoft is starting to edge out in that race, so I don't know.
Yeah, it's going to be a big thing, and we've already seen this for the last year or two, but whatever company between Microsoft and Sony, because it's not a thing that Nintendo does or can do, but to pay up the money to try to get that marketing exclusivity. I mean, it happened with recently on Microsoft with The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. You see all the commercials and say, you know, it's for Xbox One, buy it, $349, whatever.
But Even though the PC is clearly the better port.
Certainly, yes.
Definitely.
But between the two consoles, like when that gets advertised on TV, like I'm sure it's going to be that way with Battlefront and PlayStation. I think they're going to throw money behind that as well. So it's kind of a thing with this generation, even with Microsoft and doing the division for Ubisoft. Like they'll have that sort of partnership. So it's almost like they choose their sides with some of these third-party games, though. Let's get back to Halo, though. I mean, Joe and Ben, what do you think about Halo 5 opening and closing the show?
I don't think they're going to. Mm. I think I was talking with some people just last night, actually, and it was kind of brought up that they've never really done that, at least not recently. That's not been a thing. They haven't opened with a Halo game in a very long time. And honestly, I feel like I agree it's going to be like in the middle. I don't think it's going to be a finale, but I also don't think it's going to be an opener.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not too well versed in Microsoft's business. So when I answered these, I was just kind of like, yeah, whatever, I'll put whatever. So I said yes, but based on what I'm hearing, if a company really needed a strong show opening, it's Microsoft.
Mm, yeah.
And I think maybe they'll just throw caution to the wind and maybe get a little less methodical. That's really the only way I could see it opening.
That's true, and they really do need some sort of story trailer or something like that, because they've been doing the Hunt the Truth campaign, which is all the underground sort of behind the scenes sort of deal, and they put out trailers that are, oh, one's with Agent Locke, you know, putting a barrel down in Master Chief, and then there's another one with the Master Chief version, and it's the other way around. So like, they could do with something that just, you know, blows it out and like, here's what's happening. They already have the release date on Halo 5 Guardians for October 27th. So yeah, they really do need a lot of information. So we had 57% of those who entered our yes or no contest say that yes, Halo 5 will open or close the show. 57%. Let's keep on the Halo topic though. Will a Halo Reach remaster be revealed?
This answer for me was a bit of a sort of brain fart because, you know, at first I'm like, they won't do it. And then I started thinking like, maybe they'll do it. But then I submitted my answers before I changed the answer. And then after I submitted it, it's like, oh, crap, I forgot to change that answer. Honestly, I think it could go either way. I mean, I'm not really caught up with Halo as a series. And I don't know if they've released ODST for the Master Chief Collection. I know they were talking about it.
They just recently did, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe they might do a Halo Reach remaster as a sort of DLC deal, but I'm not sure. So, again, it could really go either way, in my opinion.
I think it'd be a nice thing that they do, but I don't necessarily see it as an announcement at this E3. They have to focus on Halo 5.
Yeah.
And I think any other game that, you know, takes away from that is distracting. I mean, the thing with Halo Master Chief Collection last year was they had all of those games. You could have just added, you know, more and more games. And ODST was a way to make up for the poor performance of the multiplayer, because the single player worked fine, really, last year.
Well, the thing with ODST is that, like, they released it as an apology for the poor launch, but I think they already had it in development, and they already had it in mind for DLC.
Interesting.
So maybe they'll do the same kind of thing with Halo Reach.
I think it's an interesting question. I happen to say no on this one, though.
I said no as well.
I've just put no for this one, because I don't think that they would do a Halo Reach remaster yet, really. Because if they're focusing so much on this Halo 5, I don't think they would be doing Halo Reach remaster just yet. They need a bit more Halo hype going on.
Right.
Well, actually, that can actually counter my point, actually, thinking about that. Because if they need more Halo hype, then they might do a remaster of this before the new Halo comes out. Who knows, actually. So, damn, I can see it from both angles. Oh, man.
Well, I mean, it's 4 months away until Halo 5. And it's like, would you be able to squeeze out another game in time for that? Yeah, I'm not sure about that.
Well, they don't really need to, like, do it from scratch, I guess.
Yeah.
But does it really need remastering already? I don't think so.
Right. I mean, it's an important story, but yeah, I'm not sure it does.
No.
I think Halo Reach is a little too new. That being said, they remastered Last of Us a year after it came out. So you know, this industry doesn't make any sense. So... Well,
I mean, they're remastering the entire Uncharted saga, so I guess there's no such thing as too soon anymore.
I guess not. Like, that whole thing has just been blown out of the water. That's all on Sony's side, and this is Microsoft. I do personally want to say, like, I think it's Reach is a little too new, even though it's not all that new, but...
Halo 4 was newer than Halo Reach, and that already came out.
That's true.
So who knows?
I put yes.
All right. Why did you do that?
Same answer as last one. I don't know a dang thing.
Well, you joined the 24% of people who said yes on that one, so it doesn't seem to be as possible on that one. Will Xbox One receive an updated model or price cut?
Again, it could go either way, but again, I answered no, because they've already had a whole bevy of price cuts recently, and I think going down farther would be a little ridiculous.
I think it goes on the updated model side. I think you get a confirmed, you know, finally a 1 terabyte model for Xbox One, not just like a special edition one. They also have talk about new controllers coming out, like finally controllers that have 3.5 millimeter ports in the base of the controller. So you don't have to take some stupid $20 conversion thing to fit in their little special port. So then you can plug in any headphone there. It wouldn't surprise me to see all like little tweaks done to the console, especially in preparation for compatibility with Windows 10. I'm sure they'll make, you know, the original models work, you know, very well as well. But small tweaks to the framework, I think, including the 1 terabyte. Model to support the Windows 10 functionality, because that operating system drops on July 29th. So I think that's yes. I said yes on that one.
I put no.
Okay.
I put no.
I also put no. I don't think Microsoft's gonna drop their price anymore.
No, I don't think so. Or the updated model. No, not really. I mean, unless the current model can't support Windows 10.
I mean, I could see an updated model to compete with the PlayStation 4 updated model that's coming out soon. The one that's going to have, 2 terabytes of storage? I could see that, but...
2 terabytes? That'd be interesting. Yeah, I've heard of a 1 terabyte for PlayStation.
It might have just been 1 terabyte. I don't know where I'm pulling that 2 from.
Interesting.
Yeah. At the very least, they should release, like, a new hard drive or something. Maybe that counts as an updated model.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, possible. 57% said yes, there would be either an updated model or a price cut. Now, Microsoft HoloLens, that's their virtual reality, self-contained sort of system. Will that be mentioned at all?
Nope.
I said yes, and here's why. You remember back a few E3s ago when everybody was talking about motion controls, like Microsoft was really showing off Kinect, PlayStation was really showing off the Move. I think this E3 is going to be the same for VR.
Mm-hmm.
Because Oculus and Valve are getting their VR solutions ready for launch. Like, either late this year or early next year. I haven't checked recently. But soon. And I also predicted that Project Morpheus is going to have to get a real name and get a strong library set up to go when those other VR solutions launch.
Because, mm-hmm. That's going to be a big part of Sony's show as well.
So I think Microsoft would be wise to show off the gaming potential of HoloLens this conference. That's my position on it.
Yeah, and I said yes as well, because I think it's also going to go hand-in-hand with Windows 10. And we know Phil Spencer's going to be at the PC gaming conference to talk about the Windows 10, how Xbox works with that. I think they'll also have mentioned at Microsoft how the Windows 10 works with Xbox, and then, you know, vice versa when he talks to the PC crowd. But I think HoloLens is part of that, and I think they're also looking for a 2016 launch just to try to compete with everything, and they'll talk about how everything's self-contained, that you don't need necessarily the power of Xbox One, but you're going to have Xbox One properties, certainly, with games.
You don't need the power of the Xbox One to play Xbox One games on your PC.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I'm sorry, that pissed me off so much.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's another topic for another conversation.
Mm-hmm.
I put no because I didn't remember what that was. And I was at work.
I put yes because I want to see HoloLens.
You couldn't take 5 seconds to Google it, Ben?
I could. I really could.
I want to see more HoloLens, so I put yes because I'm just being hopeful.
Mm-hmm.
I put no because I feel like they're going to focus a little more on... I feel like... If anything, maybe it'll get a small passing mention, but I feel like they're going to focus on Xbox One more than anything, like pretty much almost entirely. Because if they're going to talk about Windows 10, it's going to be at the PC gaming thing.
Well, it's going to be a big show. It's going to be like an hour and a half. They'll have a lot of stuff to talk about.
Yeah.
Yep.
So
71% said yes to HoloLens during the Microsoft conference. Now, finally here, DQP, will we see a trailer for Gears of War 4.
Well, Microsoft has been really, really wishy-washy about this, so my answer is pretty wishy-washy as well. I said no to be safe, but I honestly think, again, like every other answer here, it could really go either way. Because, I think it's a safe bet that the remake of the first game is going to show up, because that was leaked.
Yes.
But Microsoft has said Black Tusk Studios is kind of not going to be at E3, but we're not going to specify, and that's been really frustrating. So I said no to be safe.
They came out with an announcement recently that I don't think the team that's working on Gears at Black Tusk is going to be called Black Tusk. They gave them the name The Coalition.
Oh, good. It'll be more complicated.
Which is, I guess, important for Gears fans. You know, The Coalition, maybe, you know, COG. I don't know. But apparently they did say in this press release that was on Xbox Wire and Major Nelson and all that stuff that they look forward to showing the future of Gears at E3. So I think it'll be a small tease. I don't think we get anything too substantial, but I think we'll see something for the next Gears of War. But yes, as you said, you know, Gears of War Ultimate Edition with the first game, the remake, certainly. They'll absolutely show that, but yes for Gears of War 4.
And next, we'll be restructuring Rare as Ultra Tech Industries.
I think Project Connect Sports Banjo Kazooie Edition.
They Connect should release a Gears of War Connect Edition, just saying.
Apparently, if rumors are to be believed, it was worked on at one time. Like, they were coming up with something that was Connect supported for Gears of War. But
I've put yes to this because I kind of want a Gears of War if they're going to make it better than the last one, because I played all of them besides the one with the shitty characters and thought it was a bit...
Judgment.
Yeah, that one. It didn't really appeal to me. I mean, like, I bought the last Gears of War 3, completed it on the day, returned it on the same day. Wasn't amused, really. Yeah, I would like to see maybe a better Gears of War movie. Game, rather. Yeah, than a movie.
I don't have much experience with the Gears series, just bits here and there. But from my understanding, they've been coming out every couple of years, and it's been, when was the last one, 2013?
I believe so, yes.
I think we could see a trailer for something that's coming out like next year.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So I put yes.
I put no, and I don't really know what my logic was, but honestly, screw it, I'm the negative Nancy. No, they're not going to show it.
I'm just negative.
None of you get dreams.
Less people think that we'll see Gears of War 4, the next Gears of War, at Microsoft Show than HoloLens. So we have 62% think we'll see the next Gears.
I looked at my Microsoft predictions over, like, just now, and if all of my predictions are correct, it's going to be a depressing fucking conference.
Well, they need to have a good one. DQP, thank you for being on the show. We really do appreciate it.
Yeah, lovely having you.
Yeah.
Before you go, though, we do need your Big Boss and Kiefer predictions.
Okay, my predictions. I have three predictions. I have my Big Boss prediction, which is pretty ballsy. I have my Kiefer prediction, which is ballsier. And then I have the ballsiest prediction, which I am calling the Armstrong prediction for obvious reasons.
Nanomachine, son.
Okay, so my Big Boss prediction. Ubisoft, either at the end or the beginning or somewhere in their conference, confirms the existence of the sequel to my game of the year 2013, Far Cry 4, Blood Dragon 3, Vietnam War 2.
All right, another Blood Dragon.
With the return of Michael Biehn, of course.
Yeah, I could see that happening. I mean, they want to annualize their franchises, and they're not up for a Far Cry 5. So, yeah, I mean, do the offshoot and have another Blood Dragon.
Far Cry really is the only Ubisoft franchise that I'm still kind of into at the moment, because they've just been disappointing all around. So that, to me, would sort of redeem themselves for this year. Just another Blood Dragon, please.
Okay.
Now, my Kiefer prediction is, as I said, it's pretty ballsy, and that is that Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven will finally join the song list for either Guitar Hero Live or Rock Band 4.
Wow.
Ooh, that is ballsy.
That's worthy of the Kiefer.
I promise you this will become very unpleasant.
Figured it would be.
Mm-hmm.
Now, finally, the big one, the Armstrong prediction. Prediction, son. And that is that The Last Guardian and Beyond Good and Evil 2 are both announced at Sony's conference within mere minutes of each other.
Damn. Like, give us a time. Give, like, minutes. Like, just say less than 5 minutes away from each other?
Just, like, finish The Last Guardian trailer and, like, I don't know who it is. Andrew House, I think it is. And it's like, oh, by the way, one more thing. And then Beyond Good and Evil 2.
Wow.
Man, I had dreams once.
That would be.
Let me know how that works out for you.
That'd be pretty amazing.
Nanomachine, son.
See, the interesting thing with that one is that you got to think like that Ubisoft doesn't show Beyond Good and Evil 2 at their own show and then waits for Sony to follow them and then do it. That'd be something.
Well, no, they're a cowardly third party. They have to sort of align themselves with somebody. Promise exclusive DLC for that console only.
There you go. We're talking about the marketing exclusive again.
We just solved economics. Bam.
Yeah. All right. Well, all right. DQP, thank you so much. Really do appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Have a great E3.
See you later, DQP.
Bye. Don't freeze to death.
All right. Up next is River Kanoff. How are you?
Pretty good. How about you?
Wonderful. So we're here talking about Microsoft. And we have some questions that we're looking to answer as yes or no. So for E3 predictions, will Scalebound receive a release window that is more specific than just 2015 or 2016? This is the Platinum game that Hideki Kamiya showed last year. Lots of dragon riding.
To sort of illustrate how much this game has been in the public eye, last night when me and like four other people were putting together our last minute predictions, every time somebody got to this question, they said, what the fuck is Scalebound? Because nobody remembers.
I would say, given Platinum Games' track record, they would very likely use E3 as a place to give a more specific window. So, yeah, I would say there's a pretty good chance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I hope we see something like a month, maybe if it's like in the first quarter of next year. Though, with the trailer last year, it's hard to say like what even gameplay looks like.
It's more than likely sooner than you think.
Right, yeah, I'd believe that. I mean, yeah. Kamiya has a good track record with his team over at Platinum, and I'm sure it's a very action-heavy sort of thing, but yeah, that's going to be one that'll be interesting. I hope to see that earlier in the show, for sure.
Everybody is.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what it is either. I put no
because here's the thing. After I remembered what it was, after I looked it up and said, oh, right, that game looks sweet, and I put no using some of the same logic as Master of Fossils, which was... So that way, even if it doesn't happen, at least I get the question right, and that can make me feel a little bit better about myself.
Yeah, I looked it up and saw Platinum Games. I was like, okay, yeah, I'm on board. I don't need to know anything else.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it'll be there. I think if it just says 2016, it's pushing it back for another year, and maybe we wouldn't hear anything about it until TGS, and I don't think that's necessarily what's going to happen. I think, you know, Microsoft is throwing some good money behind it to get that console exclusive, and they need to show, you know, more. Let's see gameplay. Let's see something like March 2016 or Spring 2016 or what have you. So, yeah, I think yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Next question is, will we see Minecraft in any capacity during the conference? I mean, it could be a trailer for something Minecraft related. It could just pop up in a montage. Will we see Minecraft at all?
I highly doubt that Microsoft bought Minecraft just to let it sit in the sidelines. So yeah, we'll definitely see something of it. We also know that Telltale has announced their story mode game that we haven't seen anything of. So I would say E3 is probably a good place to pump up their big cash cow a little bit there.
I agree. I mean, $2.5 billion, you have to show something Minecraft related. I mean, it could even be if they do something HoloLens related, it could pop up there. Now, it's probably not going to be something like a Minecraft 2 that is Xbox exclusive. I don't think you're, you know, needing to rush anything like that out. You do have a very hungry Minecraft fan base.
You don't need a Minecraft 2. Minecraft is its own Minecraft 2.
Exactly. I feel like Minecraft 2 would be a mistake, and I hope they realize that.
Yeah. Right. But I think you got to do something, though, to get that big Minecraft fan base to pay attention to the conference and, you know, get those eyes on Microsoft products and try to drive Xbox One sales.
Yeah, it'll be there. Mm-hmm. I think your HoloLens prediction is a really good prediction.
Yeah, because you're going to get that working with PC and Windows 10. I think it all kind of falls into place. So yeah, I say yes for Minecraft.
I think so as well, because I want to see some more HoloLens at E3 as well. I think Minecraft will come into it because I want to build a little Minecraft world around the house. So if it comes out and I'm living with Peter and Mark, I'm going to be just like wandering around with this thing on my head, just pointing at everything, and they're going to look at me like I'm crazy.
Running into walls.
Yeah. Like, no, it's a creeper, fuck!
I said yes for the same reason that you guys were saying, which is Microsoft didn't buy Minecraft to just say, all right, yeah, well, we're not going to do anything with this. They're not Rareware.
Ooh.
Shots fired.
Yeah, this question's basically the free space in bingo.
Everyone's got that E3 bingo worked out, that's for sure. Yeah, 67% of people who entered our contest said yes. This is actually compared to 48% who said yes to Scalebound. So, interesting there. I would have expected more people to say everyone on board with Minecraft. All of us say yes here. Now, will the phrase powered by Xbox Live or something similar be mentioned? I mean, this was a big catchphrase for them last year. I think this is them trying to carry over the whole cloud computing idea of Xbox One. So some phrase that say, you know, this ability is powered by Xbox Live or powered by the online connectivity of Xbox, something like that. Will that be mentioned during the conference?
Well, I mean, before you said all that, I was thinking maybe this is a trick question. Because I was thinking, yeah, absolutely, they're going to bandy about their brand. Powered by Xbox Live will be mentioned more than twice. Yeah, I'm going to go with yes. I feel like it's a little too soon for them to blow us out of the water with something new. They're going to, you know, announce something absolutely outside of Xbox Live. But yeah, I think it's a little too soon for that. So yeah, we'll hear powered by.
Yeah, I think they still want to show the capabilities of Xbox Live and why it's the place you want to play. If it's something that's going to be abandoned, it wouldn't surprise me to see them abandon their TV abilities and capabilities with all that.
Oh, but that worked out for them so well.
Yeah. So that wouldn't be, you know, surprising to see them, you know, kind of throw that to the wayside and not mention that. But I think Xbox Live, they want to show how powerful it is using those cloud servers. And whether it's new Halo 5 multiplayer that's powered by Xbox Live or something like that, I think that gets mentioned, or at least some variation of that phrase. So I said yes.
Yeah, everybody tried the TV thing. Mm-hmm. I was like, you're trying to reinvent the newspaper. Why is everybody jumping into this market? That's silly. Yeah,
it worked so very well on Wii U, right?
Yeah. I hated seeing everything about TV when it came to E3 beforehand. I was like, this is games. I'm here to see games. I can watch TV already. No.
Well, it must have been very interesting. Must have been very interesting for you too. I mean, being in Europe, so many of those things were very U.S. market driven, and for a worldwide audience to be like, "Who cares?"
Yeah, basically, I don't even watch TV. I don't give a shit, really. But it's just, it is strange seeing it from a European or English point of view, I suppose, because we don't get as hyped, I guess. We're too reserved.
Man, you guys,
we're the people that say sorry for you doing something wrong.
You guys don't get as hyped for TV as America does, so like, instead of sit on the ground, you guys just like die.
Okay, the only thing I get hyped for is Game of Thrones. I'll just do that right now. That's the only thing, okay?
But that's premium joke was,
we
television.
Don't get hyped either.
Oh, okay, sorry.
America stopped caring about TV when Netflix came out.
Yeah. TV's an obsolete technology now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I said no. And what? I don't know why.
You fool!
So let's pretend that I just had a lapse in judgment and move on.
76.2% say yes, Xbox Live will be mentioned as its strength there. Now this is the one everyone wants to know about Microsoft. Will Rare's new game make use of one of their old franchises?
Franchise?
It's a newer franchise, but I think we're talking N64 days.
Nope.
No. No chance.
Look, here's the thing. All we heard from Rare last year, was this last year? Was it just Project Spark? Oh, by the way, Conker's in it too. What's that? You want a new Conker game? Fuck, make yourself. I don't care. That was all we got. I don't think they care anymore. I think they've, after Nuts and Bolts and the failures of the new Conker games and how Killer Instinct didn't do as well as they hoped it would, I am willing to bet that Microsoft has just said, fine, screw it, we don't care anymore.
I can't believe Rare is still around. It's like a thrall that Microsoft just puts money into, but it doesn't actually do anything.
Yeah,
it's a lame
basically.
Horse that's just being kept in the barn because it's got family ties and no one wants to shoot it and turn it into glue.
That's a really, really bad.
I said yes to this only because if anyone has any marketing sense in these places, they'll see these old games on Kickstarter actually doing good business and maybe want to have a little look into that.
Yeah, but there'll also be Microsoft executives that'll look at Nuts and Bolts and say, well, we gave them what they wanted once, and they didn't take it. Because they're really, really dense.
They totally get what we want, right? Yeah.
Old people.
I said yes as well, though I'm not entirely sure what they're going to go for. We know that Battletoads is in the wheelhouse. I mean, we had Phil Spencer wearing the shirt. We had its inclusion in Shovel Knight. So it's something that they can throw around. And I don't know if it's going to be like here's a small little downloadable game, not a big AAA sort of thing. But I think it's possible. I think it'd be just one of the nice surprises. And Rare's been talking about that they're going to be showing a game. So I think that's going to be one of the interesting points to look out for during this conference. But it was pretty down the middle. I mean, we had 52% of people say yes. So it's really a toss-up here. And so we'll have to watch that. Now, speaking of Phil Spencer, will he change his outfit during the course of the show?
By stop a tradition.
I actually had to look this one up. And then I was like, yeah. I hope that he realized it actually drummed up publicity, and he should maybe consider wearing different shirts throughout the show that
he's
are relevant.
Done it 2 years
that.
In a row.
Yeah. Well, they were all like, "Is he sweating up there?" It is a long time to be in the spotlight. So,
right.
That's probably exactly. What
he's
it
only
is,
getting older.
The idea that he went backstage, put on a different T-shirt, and then came back on stage. I don't know why that's so funny, but it's fucking awesome.
And you think it's part of the show that they have planned. It's like, all right, we'll have this trailer lined up. We'll have this demo lined up. Phil, you got to change your shirt.
He's so. Like, yeah, they're like, what? Reggie has my body is ready. I got to have something. I got to do
there
something.
There you go. Got to make him distinguishable. So yeah, I said yes. I think it's just one of the things he does. And he likes to show, you know, definitely to some of the indie crowds as well, because Microsoft's trying to sell themselves as we're more indie friendly. We're wearing your brand on our shirt.
I also like to think that Phil Spencer was, you know, if he, you know, played a fair amount of indie games, I wouldn't be surprised.
He gets it. I think he's one of the nicer, the more relatable big game execs out there.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's aware that indie games are all that's keeping these consoles afloat nowadays.
He is basically the only one outside of anybody working for Nintendo that is, like, a relatable human being.
I said no just because I wanted to be the different one. That's literally all it was. He might do, I don't know, but I'm just putting it out there and seeing what happens. It's a curveball. Yeah, he might just go like, hey guys, I'm Phil Spencer. Wanna play my Battletoads?
What if he changes his pants?
Rachel's like, what if he takes his shirt off on stage?
What if he changes on stage? There are so many. Look, Phil Spencer.
There's so many options.
That would be a GIF worthy moment that'd break NeoGAF.
Oh, jeez. I hope he doesn't strip on stage, though. Sorry, Phil. I'm not really that attracted to you.
I am. So you can, Phil. Don't worry.
Phil Spencer not coming back next year.
Ben, you said no.
I did say no. Because I didn't put a whole lot of thought into it. But I think, I don't know, if he didn't seem, like, too ashamed. But I wouldn't be surprised if it was, like, I don't know, similar outfits so that it wasn't too easy to notice or something.
Mm. Possibly. He's just like, I changed my belt buckle. No one will notice.
Took off my underwear.
Then he, like, points it out.
Now, the one I want to happen again, though, is somebody reminded me about this last year, last night, the guy who wore two watches. A watch on each wrist. And we still don't know why.
Maybe Pacific time and then one back home on the east. I don't know.
Maybe.
57% said yes on this one. So, River, those are your five questions. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So do you have those predictions for us?
I do.
All right, let's hear them.
My bold, it's not too bold because I don't have an idea of what exactly would happen, but I would say that it's a strong possibility in my bold prediction that a dead IP would be announced to be revived for the Vita and then canceled in the first quarter.
Oh, no.
why go that far? Canceled during the conference.
Yeah, during the conference.
Vita with
I'm
life.
Getting a call right now on stage. Oh, no, they told me to lay off that one, yeah.
Sorry,
that's
guys.
A pretty big, big boss prediction. And now your Kiefer prediction.
Okay, so you guys have been keeping up with the Italian doctor and the head transplant surgery.
Yes.
I think Kojima doesn't probably work for Konami anymore. I think he has realized a very strong marketing advantage and strategy that works for him. I have this crazy theory that I don't think Silent Hills is dead. I don't think we should count it out just yet. I think... That's why, you know, nobody's talking about it anymore is they've kind of killed it. You think in terms of, you know, Silent Hill story. Everyone who's in Silent Hill, the protagonist and whatever, they're dead. They're dead. They're in their own personal hell. I think this game had to die to be reborn in a crazy attention-grabbing way. So
River,
I wouldn't count
it
out.
This is my first time meeting you, and I hate you now because I was going to bring that up as one of my predictions.
Well, I mean, there is the rumor right now that Microsoft is trying to buy Silent Hills. By the way, that rumor is bullshit.
It is.
And
I was okay with it too. I was like, at least we get it, right?
Right. That would be a great key for prediction that Silent Hills comes back.
They're gonna call back.
Konami did pull out of the American stock market, so I would say it's not a very strong possibility that this happens at E3.
Mm-hmm.
We might get a tease of something that's eventually people will draw conclusions to being Silent Hills or something like that, and then later on we'll get something bigger at a more Japanese-centric show.
Mm.
Because Konami said, you know, we want to do more mobile, but we're not pulling out. We know that consoles are important and everything. We're not stupid.
Right.
We are stupid, but...
See, I thought you were almost going to go that, like, Dr. Sergio Canavero is going to appear on stage at Sony's press conference and be like...
That would be amazing.
Metal Gear Solid 5.
Kojima was the one that got the head transplant.
Sergio Canavero is an actual doctor, and he was pissed off that people were connecting the story to him.
It's such a wild story, that's for sure.
Oh, man. When his Twitter retweeted David Hayter... saying always have secrets, I was like,
oh god, no. Why? I didn't hear that. Oh, that's crazy.
Oh
wow.
Yeah.
So, River Kanoff, Thank you so much for being on the show. Really do appreciate it. And have a great E3, man.
You too, guys.
Bye.
Take it easy.
Bye.
All right, so now let's talk about some Sony questions. And joining us from Senshido TV is Sam, or also known as Squall Mutza. Welcome, Sam.
Hey, good to be with you guys. Call me whatever you want. I don't take offense too easily.
Sam's good.
Well, hey, Dick, that'll be fine.
Yeah, you know.
Yay!
Well, welcome, and I'm told by Rachel that you, as through connections with Senshido TV, you get to go to E3 this year.
Yeah, I mean, the tenuous connection of, you know, part owning. But so we'll be heading along for... I'm actually jetting off on Thursday to head over to kind of prep for it all. But yeah, E3 show floor, first time round, so I'm kind of absolutely wetting myself because...
You'll be fine.
It's very cool. I got to go in 2010, so it was, you know, quite some time ago, but it's just a lot of lights, a lot of noise. It's very exciting, and it's just a really cool opportunity. So we'll be talking some of these questions about Sony, and it's actually starting right off with something that you may be interested in. The first question is, will we learn the final name for Project Morpheus?
Yeah, I reckon we will. It's gotten to the point now where it's going to be entering the market, and everything's going to be kind of tied to it. It's about time for an official launch. One thing that I can probably let slip a little is that Sony's been very close-mouthed about their on-floor stuff. Mm-hmm. We've had next to no details. Arrangements for interviews, stuff like that, have been really, really heavily restricted. It leads me to believe that they've got something really big for the show floor, that they're, you know, all singing, all dancing, fireworks, the whole kit and caboodle. Yeah. So... that is kind of the only thing that I can realistically imagine it being. So, yeah, I reckon it's time.
That's really interesting to think that, you know, they keep those things under wraps. And we've seen some things like how on, like, E3's show flight, they have, like, listings of different games, and we can guess certain games. Like, there's, you know, one game that's it's a fighting or wrestling game for PlayStation 4. It's like, well, that's Street Fighter 5. I wonder what that could be.
Yeah, but, you know.
But when certain things are under wraps like that, yeah, I think this is when they need to really come out with, like, here are some of the games. This is what the final name is going to be. I'm not entirely sure we'll get, like, the release date or the release price yet. And, like, that would be interesting to get for sure. But I think we need to get away from calling it Project Morpheus, just like we need to get away from Project Natal. And, well, Connect really never took off the same way, but...
yeah.
Do we have any guesses on what the name might be?
I don't think they're going to change too far from the current name. Like, I have a feeling that they're going to somehow retain the Morpheus moniker in some way, shape, or form. I know that it's kind of breaking from their tradition to some extent. Mm-hmm. Nothing at all has been leaked out about possible real launch names, or not that I've seen anyway.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And typically you expect it to. You expect to see, oh, yeah, there's this document that someone threw out, and, you know, we went through the tip, managed to find it.
I took a picture of it really fast, but I had to, like, roll past a window, and that's why it's so blurry.
That's it, you know, like, drive-by games journalism paparazzi business, right?
Mm-hmm.
But, like, we've had none of that at all, and... yeah, I think they may actually maintain or retain rather some part of it. But that's just a kind of wild guess, wild stab in the dark, I think.
I think Morpheus is a cool name, so I'd be pretty okay if they did do that. I almost wonder if they do something like, you know, PlayStation Eyes, and they spell it really strangely. Like they had, you know, PlayStation View, which is their new TV sort of initiative where you know, kind of pick certain channels and, you know, stream it through your TV. But it's spelled then VUE, so it's just like, oh, okay, fine. I wonder, maybe like PlayStation Eyes or something like that. That'd be possible. Or if they just do PlayStation VR.
Yeah, you know, go really wild and out there, right?
Yeah. it's pretty clear to the point what it is.
I'm a big fan of PlayStation Face. Let's just call it that.
Yeah, PlayStation Face sounds good. But I actually said no.
Ooh, interesting.
But yeah, again, I said yes to the next question, so I kind of contradicted myself, like, dumbass. Because I was like, I don't know. I have no idea. I just got to throw a no in here because I'm not fucking psychic.
Joe and Ben, you said no as well.
I was not aware that they are hoping for a sort of early first half release of 2016 for this Project Morpheus. Now that I know that, it would make sense that this would be the E3 to announce it at.
My logic actually goes, it's stupid, but for me this led to a no, and maybe you'd count it, maybe you wouldn't, I don't know. But I said no because, what you guys were saying earlier, I don't think it's going to change. I think Morpheus is going to be the final name.
Hmm, interesting.
I think we already know the final name of Project Morpheus.
71% say that we'll be given the final name for Project Morpheus. Well, let's keep talking Morpheus, though. Will one of the following games have Project Morpheus functionality announced? No Man's Sky, The Witness, or Adrift?
I reckon No Man's Sky is going to be their sort of semi-flagship, oh look, we've added it onto this game sort of thing. A bit like you had like Heavy Rain with the PlayStation Move. Mm-hmm. Like, I think it's going to be like their, oh look at all the things it can do, look it's so accurate. I reckon they're going to run with that. The Witness or Adrift, I'm not sure. I mean, it could have it tacked onto, but I reckon, you know, there's so much riding on No Man's Sky already, there's so much hype behind it. If they're going to be launching Project Morpheus anytime soon, they'd be kind of crazy not to package that in together. Well, not package it directly in together, mm-hmm. but to include that as their big name for the new product.
Yeah, I think No Man's Sky is a perfect candidate for something like that. It almost just begs for it, especially when you're going in the spaceship and you're shooting down asteroids and then landing on planets. It sounds perfect for it. I think The Witness is probably going to be coming out this summer, so maybe you get like a later update if it's going to have Morpheus compatibility for that spring 2016. And yeah, Adrift is another one where we heard about it at the last the Game Awards in December, and it's like that gravity-like game where you're in space and, you know, you're losing oxygen and you're floating weightless and all that. So
yeah,
that really seems like an experience that could be really good for Morpheus or VR overall.
That would cause a lot of panic attacks.
It sure would.
But that's
part of the experience, though. It's, you know, what people are looking to do.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, like, I don't know how much you guys have used the VR stuff, but if there's a slightly creepy moment in a game, you're almost guaranteed to get a panic attack. Like, they are surprisingly immersive.
Nice.
Basically, every time you play it, you should probably be sitting on some kind of toilet facility.
Yeah, you know, some kind of paper bag to hand. You know, I mean for the breathing, clearly.
Yes. Of course you do.
Yeah, absolutely. But no, like, even like stuff with like fairly naff graphics, but still like that sort of tension horror thing, it's terrifying.
Mm-hmm.
It really is. So yeah, stuff where you're kind of immersed in a sort of life or death situation like Drift, yeah, that would work.
So yeah, I said yes on this one.
But no. I don't have a good reason.
This one, and I actually just, you know, contradicted myself from the last question, so...
To argue devil's advocate for no, I think, I mean, you're going to have Sony London probably making a lot of games for Morpheus. And, I mean, I don't know if you'll necessarily have the games already announced and say, yep, we're supporting it. Maybe for the first run of games, you're going to get some of these really simple, basic games. Almost like the first run of Move games, which were very party organized. But, you know, I guess that was almost taking off the Wii as well, because they thought, hey, that was successful, this certainly will be as well. So it's going to be interesting to see really how that develops. And I just hope they don't spend too much time on Morpheus at Sony's conference, because you have to think, like, what's the best way to show VR games?
If anything's going to get VR support, I do agree that it will be No Man's Sky. I don't even think The Witness is high enough profile to really... That, and part of me wants to say that Jonathan Blow wouldn't really jump on board with that all that quickly. I feel like he's going to want to get The Witness, the regular game, done first before throwing VR support on it.
Right.
Adrift, maybe, but I also don't think that's really all that high enough profile for them to say, like, all right, we're going to throw money behind putting this on Morpheus 2. But No Man's Sky, I could definitely see that being a possibility, because that game has kind of shot into being extremely high profile.
Yeah. Wouldn't surprise me at all if PlayStation has said, like, all right, you have a very small team, we're going to help you get this on running on our platform for Morpheus. We're just going to give you developers, make your team bigger, but we'll make it a console exclusive.
Like, that's not to say I don't think any of these games will have Morpheus functionality. I just don't think they're going to announce it this year.
Right. Mm-hmm. We had 76%, 76% say yes, that one of those games will have that functionality announced. And then going on the handheld side of things, will a new model of PlayStation Vita be announced?
I doubt it. They just seem to have sort of slowly cranked it down and down and down and down on the side of the Vita. It's not been the most wildly successful thing in the history of the world ever. I've not heard much from Sony on the side of the Vita for such a long time, and they don't really seem to almost have any passion left for it. It's just kind of like this unwanted child that they've still got attached to them somehow. They're just forced to pay for it to get through college, and then they're going to kick it out on its own.
That's a wonderful description of the Vita. I like that.
That's fantastic.
Makes me so sad.
I know. It's upsetting. Like, there's going to be like charity appeals for it and everything, but I just don't see it. I think they've just given up. They're going to take it around the back of the barn and shoot it soon. And that's kind of that.
Yeah, there's a rumor that a price cut is coming for the Vita, and it might even go down to like $89.99 US dollars.
That's a death knell, isn't it?
It really is. It really is. That's like more than a 50% cut, which is strange because, I mean, Ben, feel free to agree with me. I own a Vita. I love using it, and it has, you know, great games, but it never caught on to the AAA support. And it's almost like a machine for, you know, porting indies, or it has, you know, some semblance of success over in Japan. Mm-hmm. But yeah.
Oh, they seem to love it over there.
Yeah.
For me, it's my portable JRPG machine.
Yes, yes.
That's all it is. I love it, but yeah, not a whole lot of games.
I love using it, but it's I realize I'm certainly in a small minority of those who own it. So yeah, I don't think a new model comes out, but I think it gets a heavy price cut.
Yeah, and like to add on to that as well, like the majority of the games that tend to get produced for the Vita are kind of Japan exclusive, very Easternized titles, you know, kind of incredibly stereotypical kawaii as hell character based stuff.
We need more of that.
I'm not saying that that's a bad thing, but it's always Japan exclusive because they're too scared to port it to the West world because they think they'll sell about 6 copies. Which is probably completely untrue, but because
they'll sell kind of been 7.
Yeah, yeah, at least. Maybe 8.
Let's not get crazy here.
Yeah, you know. But I don't know. Some of them might do okay, but they've just kind of limited themselves a little bit in that way. Well, maybe not limited themselves, but they've had that limitation thrust upon them. That just kind of makes people in the West shy off of actually picking one up and using it properly.
Yeah.
I mean, I was thinking of actually a conversation we've been having recently about them bringing out a new kind of Vita. And I would kind of like them to do that because I just want them to. I think that they really need to catch up with the handheld market. To be fair, Nintendo owns the handheld market.
Yeah.
In my eyes. They fucking own it. No one else does. No one else has a goddamn chance. But I'd like to see them at least try with something. So, Sony, you're probably not going to do it, but do it, please.
If they do, they got to lower the memory card prices. That's really what ended up killing the Vita.
Or just don't make it so it has to be a bloody proprietary card.
Yeah, exactly.
Tough ones. God damn it.
Give it SD card support. Absolutely.
The 3DS has SD card support, Sony.
and that's from Nintendo.
I mean, come on.
They won't let you greet them with the correct name unless you've paid a licensing fee. Come on now.
9.5% of people said yes, there'll be a new model of Vita. So that's a slim chance, according to our community.
Oh, boy.
Let's get to Uncharted talk, though. Will a collection of Uncharted games be announced for PlayStation 4? It already happened.
Yeah. I'm reasonably certain on that one.
Yeah. It might be called Uncharted, the Nathan Drake Collection. Might come out October 9th, have the first 3
These
games.
Are some pretty bold claims that you need to back off from.
And here's the kicker. Here's the kicker. Uncharted 4 multiplayer beta. Whoa.
Yeah, I mean, that was kind of a long time coming, really, though, wasn't it? Like, they kind of need to slap them all together in a bundle to make people buy them again.
Yeah, especially with so many people coming to PlayStation 4 after not necessarily owning a Sony machine before. Definitely a way to get it in, especially after the delay for Uncharted 4. Yeah, it was one of those.
If they were gonna remaster The Last of Us the year after it fucking came out, they better have had plans to remaster the Uncharted series too.
Yeah.
for me, like, I went from PS2 to Xbox 360 to PS4 because the PS3 just had so many issues when it first came out, and I was just like, nope, not going to touch it. Funnily enough, I now have a PS3 because I want all the JRPGs, but that's another thing altogether. That's
another story.
But because of that, I kind of skipped out the whole Uncharted thing. So, like, now that there's a bundle, yeah, I'll probably be one of the suckers that goes, all right, you can have my money. I'll play all three of them in one spot. Why not?
I've played them all. I'm getting this, 1080p, 60 frames per second. The photo mode from The Last of Us remastered bundle, where you can click the right stick at any time and it freezes the game so you can go around and take pictures and all that, like... I'm excited. They're great games. Definitely pick it up, I say.
Mm-hmm.
We had 81% of people say yes to this collection, but these questions were made on May 16th, so...
Yeah. At least I'm getting one right.
There you go.
Yeah!
Will we see a gameplay demo for Uncharted 4, A Thief's End?
Yeah, I put a proviso on this. I reckon trailer, but not an in-game thing. It's either going to be kind of... in engine, in extremely inverted commas, because in engine doesn't really mean anything.
Right.
Or like some kind of flashy video compilation sort of thing. But I don't think, considering delays and all that sort of stuff, I don't think they'll have the confidence to put out an in-game sort of thing.
Well, considering last time they did, Drake fell through the fucking wormhole.
That was great.
Very good game. A live gameplay demo. So good.
Yeah. You know, I doubt they're really that keen for a repeat. So yeah, I reckon it's just going to be some kind of like heavily crafted, you know, video footage where, you know, every bead of sweat has the perfect reflection in it or something like that. Other than that, they're just not going to have the heart to do it, I don't think.
I hope said yes.
Beads and sweat are a big part of the game.
I said yes because they should redeem themselves from the last time they did a live demo because of him falling off of the earth and through the earth and into nothing. I remember watching that live at the time and I was like, oh.
Oh, that was incredible. I've never seen that happen. I mean, I'm sure it's happened, but I've never like been watching it live when it happened.
I mean, you guys make a big deal of that though, but that demo was amazing.
Oh, it was after he fell through the world. You're right.
I think this is how they open the show. And they just go out there with a bang and show that we have a firm date for 2016. I think they've said in one of their investor meetings that it's going to be before the end of March. In that, you know, still in the fiscal year. And they want to show that they just have this one scene that's specifically crafted. I mean, Uncharted 2, they had the one time at E3. They had the burning building for Uncharted 3. I think they have one particular scene that they have carved out for this demo at E3. They show it big, and then as an OEM reminder, Uncharted Collection, go do that. So I think that's how they start the show. I say yes.
Yeah, even that, or it's going to be some scene where like he really gingerly goes to buy some coffee or something, like keep him within a very strict path across the street. <You know? laughs>
No fuck-ups this time.
No, order the macchiato. It won't be safe otherwise, you know. the espresso, he's become a cup, you know. I can see that.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very successful franchise, and they pretty much need that to keep trucking along most of the time.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So we had 85.7% say there will be a demo, which is more than the collection. So very, very interesting. Now, Sam, did we brief you on the two predictions?
Yes. Right. So, I mean, I've got, like, one that's very sane based off of evidence that I know.
Hmm.
And then I've got one that, because, like, pretty much everything's got a please don't tell anyone attached to it. Right. I've had for all my email, it's just going to be completely off the wall. So the one that I feel is going to be almost certain is every reasonably well-known hardware manufacturer is going to be coming out of the woodwork with a VR, AR type headset. The one to keep your eye on will be Logitech. I think they've got a headset to bring to E3.
A Logitech VR headset at E3. That's a good big boss.
That's what I'm thinking. Just from various different whisperings and murmurings that I've heard. Mm. I could be completely wrong. They'll probably be like, this one is a 4K webcam. But I could be entirely wrong. But that's kind of feeling that I get. I think the only thing that I have seen so far with like the predictions and stuff that I've got, with the different bits and pieces that I've seen, the only thing that's really missing from E3 is just Peter Molyneux coming strolling out with something just completely off the wall, like, you know, a day in the life of a muffin and sorting out purchases for extra ingredients. If you want to see underneath the wrapping of the muffin, you've got to join in on a mobile game and tap at it frantically in order to remove the wrapper. That's going to be an additional purchase for the mobile game, of course.
Yep.
You know, that's a given. Available on all major consoles. And it will be the best game that you have ever played. Emotionally invested. There's going to be a set-out storyline about the emotions behind each individual ingredient of the muffin.
You'll be able to put a muffin in the oven and watch it bake in real time.
Yes, and that will be you inside the game. And you'll actually, you know, vaguely get the scent of blueberry from your controller. It's going to be amazing.
Now I got
to
ask.
Show a drawing to the muffin, and the muffin will react to your drawing.
Yeah, I got
to
see. Is there Milo DLC in this thing?
Oh, well, you know, you can never be too sure with Molyneux. I mean, you know, he's capable of anything. You know, it could be cookies. You know, you may even get a flapjack. I mean, he's wild.
Holy shit.
Can somebody remind me why we hate Peter Molyneux again? Because I don't actually know.
Peter Molyneux's day in the life of a muffin.
Constitutional rights no longer apply.
Peter Molyneux, seriously, that man is just a creature from another dimension. Like, he'll shout out and just be like, "Oh right, so basically, we're bringing out a solitaire game, and it's going to be really, really good. Oh, but it's going to be the best thing in the world, and you're going to be able to explore entire new universes that the human mind can't encompass. And also, there's going to be glittering diamonds in every corner of the game." Solitaire, Peter.
Molyneux, every time he comes out, he's like trying to pedal, like he's trying so hard, and then all Miyamoto has to do is be like, "Yeah, I was sleeping one day and I came up with this. Here's a game.
And I wanted to be a robot."
I wanted to be a robot, so I made a game about being a robot.
Well, Squalmatza, Sam, thank you so much for joining us. Really do appreciate your insight. What's the one thing that you're looking forward to about being at E3?
One thing I'm looking forward to at E3. Oh, it's really difficult. I think, I don't know. I'm going to the Bethesda conference, and ooh. I think the Fallout 4, like, because they've already shown the trailer.
Yep.
And I'm not sure whether they planned to do that or whether because it got linked over LinkedIn that maybe they had to kind of show. I don't know. But, like, I'm really hoping that we see something a bit more meaty of Fallout 4 rather than panned landscapes and stuff like that. So. Yeah, I'm kind of going to be on the edge of my seat for that one.
I think I've heard rumors that like they're looking to show like a half hour of it, and so I'm sure they're going to just go all out because all the indications are that it's coming this year.
Yeah. I'm like, I've seen a sort of October time or something like that.
Yeah.
So,
I want it so much. Looks so
pretty. Yeah, like I'm almost in tears watching the countdown. As it finally got to zero the other day, so
and then you had to go look it up on YouTube because it wasn't on Twitch.
Yeah, that was ridiculous, wasn't it? Like, hit zero, and I'm like, yes, please. just Google it; it'll be fine.
All right, man. Sam, have a great time, travel safely, and look forward to having a great E3.
Yeah, lovely. Yeah, it was lovely to have you here.
Yes, well, you know, you guys clearly have quite low standards.
Well, I mean, I'm on this show.
I don't know what to say, but it was great being on. I look forward to catching this when it's all out and ready.
Great. All right, have a great one. Thanks.
Catch you later. Bye.
All right, let's keep it rolling with Darkerye. How are you?
Tired.
Tired. Very tired. It's been a long day. Got to rest up this week for E3 hype.
Yeah, I've been watching the Mario 602 speedrun race.
Ooh.
Which is a race through Super Mario 64 120, Super Mario Galaxy 120, Super Mario Sunshine 120, and Super Mario Galaxy 2 242.
Oh my goodness.
Darn.
It is a 24-hour run if you're good.
That's amazing. Very impressive. Well, let's get back to talking about Sony, though. Question here, will Gran Turismo 7 be revealed?
This one was kind of a coin flip for me. I think I literally flipped a coin for this one. I'm going to say probably. People, I did a quick Google search, and like people are talking about it as though it's a given. So I'm assuming, sure. This is the one question I have no real insight in.
Hmm. I am going to tell a story of how at my place of work, we finally revealed that there's an SRT vehicle being developed as DLC for Gran Turismo 6.
Ooh.
And it's something I'd known about for maybe like a year and a half. And it's like, it's finally great to see it be announced and be involved in the reveal and all sorts of stuff. We even had Kazunori Yamauchi, the head of Polyphony Digital, come out with, you know, translators and everything to, you know, talk to the media about this car, because like it's a big deal at the basically the end of their Vision Gran Turismo sort of DLC cycle for GT6. And so like it took a while to schedule and everything. And yeah, they brought automotive media, so I wasn't about to, you know, risk losing my job and ask game questions, because that's not my place. But I'm thinking, like, kind of strange to be doing this at the end of the GT6 cycle. I mean, if it was tough to schedule a meeting here, you're probably making Gran Turismo 7. And it wouldn't surprise me at all if it had Project Morpheus support, because that just seems perfect for that kind of game. So I think it will be revealed, especially with, you know, the Project Morpheus stuff. It wouldn't surprise me at all if that announcement's coming.
I put no, because the only racing game I really tend to play at the moment is Mario Kart. So I don't really know much about other racing games. I don't know much about racing games, really. I'm not going to lie.
Back when the PS4 came out, they were pretty excited in Japan of like how powerful the console was compared to the 3. And I believe Kazunori like actually said, like, yeah, no, I'm excited like for the PS4 because it's going to make Gran Turismo 7 really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think it's slated to come out. Like, he was hoping that it would come out in either 2015 or 2016.
Yeah, so that would be the time.
Yeah, no, I don't see any other reason.
Yeah. Now, we had 43% of people say yes. So, yeah, it's getting close to that. It's that 50-50 point, maybe yes, maybe no. But more Sony studios are looking to reveal their PlayStation 4 game, because when Shuhei Yoshida was asked, like, yeah, every studio is working on a PS4 game. So will Guerrilla Games, Bend, or Media Molecule reveal their PlayStation 4 game?
So I said no for this one.
Hmm.
Media Molecule especially no. They just had Little Big Planet. I don't think they're ready for something new.
See, they didn't make it, though. Sumo Digital was behind 3.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
And I think it's a small team behind Tearaway as well. So it wouldn't surprise me if the remaster for Tearaway is just a way to get Media Molecule more money.
Well, this is unfortunate, then.
I don't think you're alone in that. I think you see Little Big Planet, you assume Media Molecule,
No, that's where I was, too. I'm in the same boat.
Mm.
Bend, if I remember correctly, they've just made Vita games so far, right?
Yeah, they were behind Uncharted Golden Abyss recently. Mm-hmm. Or 3 years ago? But that was one of their last big games, and I think they've been working on their PS4 game ever since.
I think, if anything, they're most likely to announce something new.
Though, now, word is it's supposed to be, like, according to rumors, like some sort of horror game. So that'd be interesting in conjunction with, you know, Until Dawn, that's still going to be coming out.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Bend, I don't see as high profile enough to be in a big E3 announcement. Guerrilla Games, they're Killzone.
Yeah,
they were kind of a toss up. I wasn't totally certain about them. Ultimately, I went with no. I think they're more of a bigger game developer, so I think it'll be another year or so before they have something. But that one was more of a toss-up. But now that I know that Media Molecule, in fact, did not make Little Big Planet 3, perhaps I made the wrong decision.
Mm. With Guerrilla Games, there's concept art that is out there, supposedly connected to them. This was maybe like a year or two ago that it leaked. But it has like robot dinosaurs. And with a code name of Horizon.
They shoot lasers when they roar.
I don't think they do. But it looks pretty cool. It has a code name of Horizon, and I think it may be the year for it, but I could see it, you know, taking another year, or it gets pushed to the France event, like the Paris show that Sony is doing, because they're skipping Gamescom this year. Because it's so soon after E3, like E3's a week later, Gamescom's a week earlier this year, so they're moving to like a France event. And it wouldn't surprise me that for a European developer, we might see Guerrilla's game there. But I think it's Media Molecule and probably Bend this year for Sony. And Media Molecule, especially with Morpheus, I think like they might involve like Move and Morpheus and DualShock 4 and like different ways that you can play their game. I mean, because yeah, it's Little Big Planet 2 is the last one that the big Media Molecule team last worked on. That's a long time ago. So they probably got, you know, the tech first. And we saw them at the reveal event for PlayStation 4 with the puppeteer dancing sort of thing. So they've got something in the works. I think we see it.
I didn't recognize any of these studio names because I'm garbage. So I just
don't. Oh, wait, crap. I said yes. Ha ha!
Well, 76% of people who entered said yes. So we will see if one of those three get it done. Now, Level 5 is apparently confirmed to reveal a JRPG at Sony's conference, so they say. And a partnership with Sony for an exclusive PlayStation 4 game. The question is, will that game be revealed to be a new IP?
I said yeah. I don't believe Level 5 really messes with other people's franchises very much. And unless they plan on bringing Fantasy Life over to PlayStation, they don't really have anything under Sony. So I think this is going to be
they have one game.
Nino Kuni?
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to be another Nino Kuni.
I think it's Nino Kuni too.
That reaction. I do.
I don't see Nino Kuni getting a sequel.
I don't know.
That seems like I admittedly never played it, but it seems like a really self-contained game to me.
That just depends, because like Ghibli's going through a weird transitional period right now.
Anybody that does not know,
Hayao Miyazaki recently retired, and the movie they just came out with over here is rumored to potentially be their last movie for a while.
Wow. Again.
I mean, it's Ghibli, so we don't really know how that's going to actually go, but
literally every Ghibli movie for the past 10 years has been their last movie.
Yeah.
Miyazaki retired after, like, all of them.
Yep. That being said, Level 5 makes a surprising amount of shit, and they haven't made some of their stuff for a while. Like, I am surprised at how much they make. So, for all we know, there could be some buried IP out there they haven't touched in years that they're bringing to PS4, which I personally think is a little more likely than Ni No Kuni 2. But I could definitely see logic behind Ni No Kuni 2. It is possible. I just don't think it's happening.
Mm. We're going to be seeing a sequel to Dark Cloud, their first game on PlayStation 2.
Rogue Galaxy as well.
Released in 2000.
I would love a new Dark Cloud. No BS.
Mm. I think it'll be a new IP because it seems like they come out with a new IP every couple of years. Mm. Like, they make a lot of different games. Some of them times it's just a one-off, but they make a lot. If not, I think it's Inazuma 11 for Wii U.
Ooh. And we get to hear Inazuma about Layton 7 as well.
Inazuma 11 for Wii U at the Sony conference.
Yes.
Well, we had 29% of people say that, yes, it'll be a new IP, so maybe some more people hoping that it's Ni No Kuni 2. Now, will a sequel be announced during Sony's conference in which the last game in its series was released within the last 5 years?
Probably. Sony loves their IP. They're not like Nintendo, where they go like 10 years without an F-Zero game. If they have an IP that's going successfully, they tend to, you know, have a good turnaround on it that doesn't last too long. So I don't necessarily know what that game is going to be, but I'm confident that we're going to see a sequel to a recent-ish game be announced.
Yeah, a lot of people are pretty confident, 81%, but I'm not so much. Though I could see a third party announcing a game with Sony's, you know, partnership help, like during PlayStation Expo with Street Fighter V, something like that. I mean, that would have definitely qualified. If Capcom says, hey, let's do another DMC game, that would count as within the last 5 years. I said no, though, because I think they have other games that are either going to be new IP or we know about them, and so it won't be, you know, anything new. I just took a stab and said no.
I just really put no, because I don't really think that they will, really. No particular reason behind it. Just, I can't really back it up with anything.
Yeah, it's one of those tough questions.
I just don't see them doing it, really.
I said yes, because I think it's very, very likely that if an IP sells well, Sony's not stupid. They're going to make it.
Yeah. I mean, we're going to see things like, you know, Ratchet and Clank, but then again, that doesn't qualify as in the last 5 years. So it'll be interesting to see their conference for sure. And the last question, will the phrase U.S. dollars be mentioned?
No. That is not a meme that works in their favor.
No, it's not. But it's a question we have to ask every year. The question is if Project Morpheus gets a price point, will it be said?
I say no to this question every year because in my heart I hope they'll learn.
I didn't think they did it last year.
They did not.
No.
I hope they keep learning.
I don't believe they've done it since PlayStation 3 because it's the kind of thing that bit them in the ass enough that there's no way in hell they'll do it by accident. Mm-hmm. And it's not like My Body Is Ready where they can do it on purpose.
Yeah.
It's just not going to happen.
Yeah, it's I put no as well, but can you imagine what would happen if they did?
Mm-hmm. Someone's getting fired if they do.
Yeah.
I put yes because USD is the proper term for our currency on a global spectrum. And they're business people. They understand.
That's actually pretty sound reasoning.
It's US dollars.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, what the fuck are you bringing sound reason?
It's actually United States dollars. Thank you.
Ooh. Ooh. So Darkrai, your big boss and Kiefer predictions.
I didn't manage to come up with anything that was reasonable enough and still unreasonable enough to be a big boss prediction, unfortunately. It's not a very creative year for me as far as thinking of legitimate things. I think I have an alright Kiefer prediction.
Alright, let's hear it.
It's nothing terribly special, but I believe that we are going to see a Super Mario Sunshine sequel starring the Inklings.
Ooh, that's pretty Kiefer.
This office demands results. That's what I provide.
Splatoon used to be featuring Mario characters, if I'm not mistaken.
I think the original incarnation was actually with rabbits.
Oh, really? Interesting.
Why?
But I think we're going to see Super Mario Sunshine 2 featuring Mario facing off against the Inklings.
Hmm. Gosh, I wonder if there were, like, DLC of Mario with a flood in Splatoon.
I saw a fake leak for that.
Yeah, I saw that, too.
I wanted to believe, but it's not likely.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty interesting, though. Thank you for joining us, Darker. I really appreciate your time.
Of course.
Have a great E3.
To you as well.
All righty.
Love you.
Love you.
All right, now let's get into the show. We're talking about Nintendo questions, and joining us is the one and only Falero. How are you?
I am perfectly me.
All right.
Good answer.
That's all we could ask for.
Yeah.
Let's start talking about Smash Brothers. Will a new Super Smash Brothers downloadable content character be revealed?
The question should be, is the sky blue?
I'm going to go with yes, though I don't know if there's going to be any footage, because I don't know how long it takes for them to develop a character. I mean, I'd assume that would take a while, but my money is definitely on it being Dynamite Heady.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what they do with that, because they talked for so long about, oh, Mewtwo, it takes a long time for Mewtwo, and we are going to announce him in like October, but then he doesn't come out until... Was it March or something like that?
Well, to be fair, they were also finishing an entire game alongside of Mewtwo.
Yeah, but then they announced, they say Lucas on April 1st, which, you know, April Fool's say what have you. But then now, a couple days ago, they're from when we recorded this, they're like, oh, yeah, Lucas is going to be June 14th in the morning. So, what, like a 2.5 month turnaround? It is really hard to say how long it takes for them to make a character, though I do think one is definitely going to be announced. I think it'd be really cool if we see... a Smash Brothers trailer reveal for it.
I wonder if it's going to be as buggy as Mewtwo was.
Yeah, Mewtwo was pretty buggy that first time around there.
It was pretty fun, though.
Yeah, looks of it. The question, though, is if there is one, who Who will it be?
I'm gonna go with Ryu. I don't know why. Just, you know, there's been a rumor of Ryu being
there.
Rumors.
Okay with that.
I like rumors. They sound tasty. But yeah, I'm thinking something like Ryu.
A Ryu that can costume change into Ken. It'll be perfect.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, and Akuma.
Yeah, exactly.
Just get the whole cast in.
Pretty much. Like, I mean, Sakurai's really good with those alternate costumes and different palette swaps, so I think he'd do definitely something like that. I would say Ryu as well. I think that's the one that makes sense for E3, and you know how well Mega Man went over with that Capcom partnership a couple of years ago. Do it with Ryu again. Have it be, you know, to cross and open up the trailer, and Mario and Link are playing some Street Fighter, and then it Hadouken. It's real life. That'd be pretty cool. I think
it would be
really
good if they trolled us with Rayman. Considering.
Well, the thing is, I don't think it's going to be any of the ballot characters yet.
No, it's too early for a ballot character.
Yeah. No, definitely not.
And we have a standing prediction on this in one of podcasts that it should be Wonderful 101 if it's going to be a ballot character.
I think Wonder Red's going to be the first from that, is what I was saying.
Well, I'm just thinking, like, if they have this ballot for people to vote, what's to say that they're only going to take one suggestion from it?
Well, I think they'll do more, and I think it would be smart if Nintendo laid out a plan for DLC. Because, yes, it's going to be Lucas, it's going to be that Miiverse stage, it's going to be extra costumes like Splatoon costumes for your Mii. I think there's probably also a KK Slider one running around as well.
That'd be cute.
It would be cute. They need a plan, though, because Mario Kart 8, they had the Pack 1 and Pack 2, and yeah, they came out, you know, separately, but at least we knew the schedule. If they say, like, we're going to plan to release 4 characters from the ballot and we'll have them in this month, I think that would be smart. I'd like to see that at Nintendo's E3 digital event.
No, I personally think we're going to see not just one DLC character, but 2. I don't think they're going to be newcomers, though, personally. I think that it's going to just be more closing in the holes. Mm-hmm. So, personally, my theory is that it's going to be Roy and Wolf. But that is just me.
Can we honestly have more than one Roy in this game? I mean, I don't know.
I made the joke yesterday that they're just going to replace Bowser Jr. with Roy, but like the graphic is just going to be Roy's character portrait crudely taped over Bowser Jr. Like, the model when you're fighting is going to be Bowser Jr. It's going to be Bowser Jr.'s, all of his stuff, but it's going to be like a crude Photoshop of Roy from Fire Emblem's face just over him. That's what I want.
They'll have to get Xander to re-record, and one will be Roy, and the other be Roy.
Roy?
Well, we had 95% of people who answered our question to say yes, so I think that's a pretty sure thing.
I will be, like, really surprised if they do not announce anything.
I mean, with how successful Mario Kart DLC is, I think Nintendo's now going full-on into DLC and other different business models, like mobile games. So will the first Nintendo and DNA mobile games be revealed?
Well, if they do, they can release the mobile game so only 10 people can download them at a time. And sorry, just thinking amiibos.
Yeah. Absolutely gonna happen. They're gonna get right on that because, you know, mobile gaming is the future. Just ask Konami.
Yeah. It's the future.
Oh, yeah.
It's the future.
They've got this lockdown pet. Nobody hates them at all.
Absolutely. If they do, I'd like to see them do it with Pokemon because so many people already bootleg it onto a mobile as is.
Yeah, that's true. Just thinking Pokemon, and if it goes to Wii U and the amiibo possibilities that way.
I'll get to that later.
Yeah, I don't know if you heard this because the Pokemon amiibo have apparently
been Dex numbers.
Yeah, they've been coded in their, like, the data with their national Pokedex numbers, basically leaving the possibility open for more to be added.
That's terrifying.
It is.
Yeah, no, people are going to die.
But as far as mobile and DNA, I don't think it happens yet. I think it happens in, like, Nintendo Direct later down the line, especially, you know, Japan market first, because DNA is a big deal over there.
We just heard about this deal, like, what, a month ago? It's too soon.
No, it was a few months ago, but I think it's too soon as well. I think they need to focus on, you know, the last legs of the Wii U and continuing momentum for the 3DS. I think that's what this needs to be about. And I mean, if you want to talk about, you know, bringing the new Club Nintendo version, because that's supposed to be at the end of the year, I mean, that's one thing. But I don't think the mobile games just yet.
Mobile games, I don't exactly want Nintendo to go for it, but, you know, if they feel they gotta.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Gotta maximize on the profits.
Yeah. And that's, and they're good at that. But, yeah.
Well, we had 29% of people say yes, so we'll see what really does happen. Maybe an Animal Crossing game for Wii U. Will that be revealed?
Yes.
Yes. Sure, yeah. Why not?
Yeah.
I'm saying yes because I want to believe, but at the same time, I don't actually think it's going to happen because New Leaf is too new, personally.
Hmm.
That being said, Nintendo, I want an Animal Crossing game for the Wii U.
Newer Leaf.
Is it like New New York? They named it twice or some shit? I don't even know.
Yeah, it's like couscous.
What the fuck is couscous? It looks weird.
It's nice they named it twice.
I mean,
there's been a lot of focus on Animal Crossing lately. Like, they've been doing all this DLC stuff with Isabelle. It's pretty crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's it. Everyone's crazy about Isabelle, so they're making another game. It's gotta be it. They're happy to cater to the furry demographic. I mean, you have to look at those cat suits in 3D World. They know what they're doing.
Exactly, and then also in Monster Hunter 4 as well. Mm. So they made the Town Plaza app a while back. So they're used to, you know, having Animal Crossing on Wii U. They have Happy Home Designer. They're putting out the amiibo cards for that game. I think an Animal Crossing Wii U game should be all but a certainty.
I think it should go along with the new game.
Yeah, right? You design the homes, you export them to the Wii U game. It sounds so logical, but
I think it's because like the designing homes one does sound a bit lame by itself.
Mm.
I probably still play it. But
talk about.
Although to be fair, actually, you know, I can't really say that because the main reason I play games like The Sims is to make houses.
Maybe they'll go a step further. You're the mayor in New Leaf, right? Maybe you'd be the president in this one, the president of the Animal Crossing world.
Yes.
No, the dictator.
Yes,
power.
It's like, give me the power to kill.
Or you can be a president or a dictator. There's a light and dark story.
And you have to buy them separately, but there might be a third story as DLC.
Yeah, a femme fatale version of Isabelle. Oh,
God. Peter, that reaction. Oh, God.
Oh, get on that dark side of the internet.
What did I get?
I've seen some art.
I would imagine.
Ben's like, I've seen some things. 71% say Animal Crossing on Wii U, but will there be a new line of amiibo figures, like a new game line? So we've had Smash Brothers, we've had Super Mario, we've had Splatoon so far. Will there be a new game line of amiibo revealed?
Absolutely. They've got to give the scalpers the work.
Now, we have to consider, I think, would the reveal of Chibi Robo before E3 and after these questions were put out, does that count?
It's a line, and Chibi Robo is one singular amiibo.
Yeah.
So I feel like they need it needs to be a new line.
Okay.
Sonic Boom!
Sonic Boom 2. I think it's going to be Animal Crossing. I think if Animal Crossing Wii U comes out, like, yeah, they have the cards, but I think the possibility of things like you have the villager amiibo compatibility, adding something like Isabelle on top of that,
maybe we'll finally get that Tom Nook amiibo they've been showing us since day fucking one.
Oh, right.
I like that, actually.
Either Animal Crossing, I could see, if there was like a WarioWare game, I could see that.
Yep.
And like different amiibo figures could unlock more micro games.
Like Ashley.
But there would need to be another WarioWare game. That's not Game and Wario for that to happen. So Nintendo, if you could get on that.
I think maybe Fire Emblem.
Mm.
It's getting a bit bigger over here.
Yeah.
I just want a Fire Emblem line.
They're so difficult to find for Smash Bros. Though. Like, that's the one big gap in my collection.
Yeah.
Nearly got one last night, and then it was all out of stock.
Yeah.
Oh, well. That happens.
Other franchises. I don't know, man. Sonic Boom is a big one for me. I don't know.
You get Tails and get Knuckles, Shadow, Sticks. I mean,
absolutely, Sticks. That's Everyone's
in fact, that'll just be the only amiibo they make. We'll just make a sticks one. We'll burn all the other amiibo.
And Sega will rule the amiibo lines. We had 90% of people say yes. I mean, the amiibo craze goes on.
It's just free money for Nintendo.
Mm, yeah, which they're not making on Wii U. So then will the next mainline series Pokemon game that is not a spinoff be revealed for 3DS?
As far as I am aware, they've never announced a Pokemon game at E3, have they? X and Y wasn't at E3, was it?
It wasn't at E3. Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire was announced like a month before E3. And yeah, still came out that year.
I don't think they've ever announced a Pokemon game at E3. I don't think they're going to start now. And a lot of my saying no to this is a lot of me saying, hey, Nintendo, please don't make a Pokemon game this year.
Yeah, please, you're still doing your live decks, aren't you?
Please take a fucking vacation so you can make a good one again. I beg you.
Yeah, I don't think we'll get it at E3, but I think we're going to get it. It's probably going to happen. Mm. Pokemon Joy and Misery. That'll be the titles.
I don't think we'll get another one yet. I'm thinking next year.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, take a year off. I mean, it's been every year since 2009 with Platinum, Black and White 2, X and Y, Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire. It's been year after year after year, and so take a break, yeah.
I'd like for them to take more than a year off. I would like a couple years, maybe 5.
The thing is, they sell so much, and they make so much money off of it that, like, you can't ignore that. And isn't it weird to think that the only, I mean, the question's about 3DS, but for Wii U, like, Rumble U is the only Pokemon game on Wii U. That's so strange. I mean, you talk about Pokemon Snap, too, and all the possibilities there, and there's no stadium equivalent. I mean, yeah, you had Battle Revolution on Wii, but nothing there for Wii U. It'd be strange to not see a Pokemon game this year, but I think it needs to happen, so I said no.
I just want a new one, so I said yes.
Yeah. So we had 23.8% say yes to a new Pokemon game this year at E3. So, Valero, did we tell you about the different predictions that we do at the end of this segment here?
Here's my bold prediction, okay? Let's get us some Sega versus Capcom. Now, it's more hopeful than anything. Because it probably won't be announced at E3, but you never know. I was just thinking, Archie's World Unite comic has got a lot of people full of hope, and I'm in that group. Yeah. I know Project X Zone is already a thing, but a proper, you know, like a Marvel vs. Capcom type game with that, I'd be all over that.
Sega versus cool. Capcom, that's pretty big boss. I like it.
I want that. I agree with that. I'd take it.
Yeah, I go with that.
All right, let's hear the crazy one though.
Okay, so. BioWare, they're going to get into the dating sim genre. I mean, the games are basically those already, so you might as well trim the fat, get rid of all the RPG stuff, get on Hannah full boyfriend, you know?
Oh, God.
This one wishes Senpai would notice them. That's my dream game.
BioWare makes a dating sim.
I'll do my job. You people better start doing yours.
That's fucking amazing.
That'd be something. I mean, they talked about a new IP last E3. They were showing beautiful vistas and all these sorts of things. But nope, dating sim.
Absolutely.
Well, Falero, thank you so much for your time. Really do appreciate it. Thank you for joining us.
No worries.
Yeah, lovely to have you.
All right, have a great E3.
Hello. Right.
Let's keep the Nintendo questions going with Cyberlink 420. How are you, Luke?
I am doing well, and I would just like to point out for the record, I called Ryu on this show 4 years ago, so
you did.
My predictions come right, they just take a while.
You did. That's right, and I think it's going to happen.
I believe.
Yeah, we were just talking about that with Smash Brothers DLC earlier, but let's get you in a question on, will Retro Studios' next game be revealed?
Absolutely not. Traditionally, it's been around a 3-year gap between retro releases. So like Prime 2, 3 years, Prime 3, Prime 3, 3 years, Returns, 4 years, Tropical Freeze. So I think it's a little too early. I think we're not going to get retro until like a random direct at the end of the year or the start of next year.
Mm. Would it even be something that they maybe push to NX?
Potentially. I don't know how far out NX is. Like, that's the big question. Because it's like, if you have, you know, a retro game at launch, that would be a big way to push the system and get people on board. But I don't know what the time frame is like, or, you know, any of the NX specs or anything like that. So it could, you know, take an extra amount of development time, or they could be, you know, have enough time to get something out for Wii U before it ends and then save something for like year two or year three of NX.
Yeah.
So it's hard to say.
I said no as well. I think Nintendo just has many other games they could possibly show, and I don't think it needs a big retro hit to, you know, end a conference or something like that.
I said no on it too.
Yeah, because Tropical Freeze was just only so recently ago. I mean,
yeah, it was last year. It's been about a year exactly. Some change.
February of last year.
That's right.
I don't think they will. That being said, I said yes because I want the next Donkey Kong game. And I want it to have the Kremlings in it, and I'm going to keep saying yes every year until I get that.
Who says it would be DK? And if it's DK, who says it's retro? I mean, for all we know, Donkey Kong Country Returns 3 could be what Next Level Games is working on, because I know they're working on something that's going to be revealed soon.
That's true.
As long as Karul's in it, and it's good, it's all I want.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I said no to this one as well. I don't see them doing that yet. Maybe eventually. Not yet.
All in due time.
I mean, you get people hoping for Metroid. They're in a studio did Metroid Best recently.
I put yes because I know that they've been working on their next game ever since Tropical Freeze was done. I could see, like, just a little snippet. You know, just a character. And then a logo. That's all we'd really need. I mean, they've been working on something on this long enough.
We had 62% of people say yes, so the hype for retro is there.
I think 62% of people are going to be disappointed.
Yeah, just asking for a lot from Nintendo. Like, will the concepts presented last year in Project Giant Robot or Project Guardian appear in a full Wii U game?
I said yes. I don't think that Star Fox logo in those demos was there by accident.
I think so, too. I think it gets all integrated into Star Fox in some capacity. You know, how for Giant Robot, especially, with how strange it looked to move all about. But, you know, it's Miyamoto and all of his ideas, and I think to make a better Star Fox game,
See, for me, Giant Robot was the one that would have been more likely. That makes a lot more sense for me to have been in a Star Fox game, because, like, space fighter people, obviously they're going to have a giant robot at some point.
Oh, naturally. It's going to be the new Great Fox.
Yeah, it's going to be a boss that you get to play as the boss for once to try to stop all of the R-Wings. And
Fox is going to get in a Landmaster. That Landmaster is going to get into this robot, and the robot is going to get into this Landmaster. We're going to Gurren Lagann this shit. And
Landmaster!
The Blue Marine, the Landmaster, and the R-Wing are going to all combine like Constructicon style to form Star Fox Devastator.
But, I mean, Guard? What about Project Guard with all the different monitors and whatnot?
That's Sly 5. The whole game is now the Belgium Sewers.
Because that was such a great segment.
On Nintendo.
On Nintendo now.
Again, I do think that that's going to be tied into Star Fox somehow. It could be related to, like, an on-foot mission or a hacking minigame or something like that. But I think it is still Star Fox.
Yeah. That seems to make the most sense.
I've never actually played a Star Fox game. I'm just going to say that right now. I remember there was a video where Miyamoto was in it, and you could tell that there was some Star Fox going on the screen, even though it was blurred.
Well, yeah, he did that on purpose to make people mad.
And I was like, right, we need to see that at E3. Show us what you've been playing.
Oh, that was the best. That was the best.
Man, remind me when the SMYNiversary comes around. I need to bring Assault so we can do some multiplayer.
That's right. I have it, so we're good. It was like Halo on the GameCube.
It was all we had.
Yep. We had 67% of people say yes, that they will appear in a full Wii U game. And yeah, it just makes sense that it would be Star Fox. Now, will an HD remaster of a game be announced for Wii U?
I think the odds are pretty good just because there's a lot of games that, you know, if HD remastered, would sell gangbusters. And there's a lot for them to, you know, pull from. So I think the odds of at least one HD remaster, even if it's not from Nintendo themselves, is pretty good. Especially considering that's kind of the trend that's been going around a lot with the industry in general. So
Wind Waker did pretty well, so I think it's pretty likely.
Yeah, I was hoping for one last year. I definitely hope for one this year, but I'm not sure if Nintendo's going to follow that strategy. I'd like them to. I think it's a good way to try to extend the life of the Wii U, especially if they're starting to think towards NX to remaster old games. And yeah, Wind Waker did very well, changes they made.
You think this is TwiPrize year?
It might be. And that may be a big boss or Kiefer prediction for someone here.
I've seen a lot of people say that they want an HD Mario Sunshine. So that is also a possibility.
Because
I know that is a very popular want for people.
Feel like Delfino Plaza as a map in Splatoon is more likely.
that's yeah. Awesome.
That would also be really cool.
Or Galaxy 1 and Galaxy 2.
Oh yeah, that's. They're already selling Galaxy 2.
Yes,
on the
I would say shop. Galaxy. I would say like the Galaxies are probably off the table if they're going to be releasing them on the eShop, which they've already done with one, obviously. And
I think they are going to come out with one on the eShop.
I'm sure eventually.
Yeah, because that was part of the Japanese Nintendo Direct, not the Direct Micro that America got, but that was part of that news that they're getting Galaxy 1 on the eShop.
It's only a matter of time.
So that should be interesting. But yeah, I said no, and I was actually the only one of our hosts here to say no, because as much as I'd like to see it, I don't necessarily see Nintendo going after that strategy.
Well, again, yeah, not necessarily Nintendo. They got to use that, you know, back catalog however they can in some cases.
62% said yes to an HD remaster. But we were talking about Virtual Console, so will the Virtual Console, the new Club Nintendo program, or NX be mentioned in the Nintendo Digital event?
Virtual Console, yes. NX, hell no. It's way too early. They even said it's not going to happen. And new Club Nintendo, more likely than NX, but still I don't think it's going to happen. I want to
believe they're going to talk about it. That being said, I don't think they're going to talk about it.
Yeah, I think the wound is too fresh.
I think you're right, too. I mean, they will definitely have to talk about one of the two, Club Nintendo, probably.
I feel like Club Nintendo successor is another one of those random direct in the middle of the year type announcements.
Possibly, actually. You might be right there.
I am not sure about Virtual Console, actually. And this may be still just me being cynical about mentioning, yeah, you have certainly the N64 and DS, and they could certainly roll out announcements with that. But the time in the digital event is precious. They keep it to like about 45 minutes, and that's a tight show, especially if you're trying to show more things. So I'm just not sure it gets mentioned. Like I said, I don't think the new Club Nintendo program gets mentioned at E3 in that digital event. And yeah, NX, it's way, way too early. But I'm just going to be cynical about the Virtual Console. As much as different options that they have, it'd be really cool to see, you know, GameCube Virtual Console games like downloaded through the eShop, that'd be really nice. I just don't think it's going to necessarily happen. But we have 81% of people saying that it will.
Yep.
The likelihood that they'll just show, you know, like a quick 30-second sizzle reel of stuff coming to Virtual Console on 64 and DS is pretty good.
Possible.
Ben and I have a lot of Virtual Console games now. We both bought Mario 64 and Donkey Kong 64 when that came out, and they're getting better. Like, they're getting better about Virtual Console. That's not to say they're doing great yet, because it's still kind of barren, especially compared to the Wii's. But
the Wii was barren for a long time, too.
It was, and you'd think they'd learn from that, but they didn't. Like, it's getting better, and I feel like we're going to see a couple more N64 games, and I think they're going to see a couple more GBA games at least, if not some DS games too, personally.
All right, now the final Nintendo question. Will the phrase, up until now, be mentioned in the Nintendo Digital event?
Up until now, I've always said no, and that is continuing this year.
Same. It's just not a common thing for them to say. And we just put it in here from the Smash
Bros.
The Brothers
legacy
days.
Factor.
Yeah, absolutely.
See, I've actually said yes, because it's something I can imagine Reggie saying. I can just imagine him saying, up until now, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, yeah. I think Reggie's going to say it.
Yeah.
Up until now, we've had no intention of releasing Mother 3 in the United States. And that is going to continue this year. Moving on.
That's basically what they did last year.
Up until now, we've been really fucking up with how we provide you amiibo. And from now on, we still will.
Now we're just going to give one of every amiibo to every city. Not store, city. Good luck!
Retail exclusive.
No. Good luck.
I said no. It's one of the few things I said no for on the Nintendo section.
Like, honestly, it's... Because up until now isn't really a collection of words that come up very casually. You have to, like, mean to say it. And, like, Smash Community is literally the only people who latched onto that.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Yeah, I said no as well. But we had 33% of people say yes.
33% of people are probably wrong.
Well, we'll see what happens when that Nintendo Digital event rolls around. Cyberlink, thank you for joining us. I hear you have quite the handy amount of predictions.
I have four for big bosses and four keepers. Pick a number.
All right, let's just lay them all on us.
Oh, all of them?
Yeah, let's bring it on.
Okay, like I said, next level games. We're going to see what they're working on this year.
All right.
That PC showcase they're doing at the very end, Killer Instinct PC. It's happening.
Killer Instinct on PC. I mean, with the Xbox One games, I'd say that, yeah.
I feel like that is the one that everybody's been asking for, and if they're serious about, you know, Xbox One, PC kind of coexisting, that's going to be the one they push.
Mm-hmm.
That question about Minecraft presence at E3, yes, with an asterisk, because it's going to be the first reveal of Minecraft Story Mode.
Okay. Because
right. That's still due out for this year, as far as we know.
Oh, really?
True. Jeez, we haven't heard anything about it other than its general announcement.
I mean, if it's Telltale, we might just hear it the week before it's out.
Yeah. And then my last big boss prediction, Battletoads. The Rare project is Battletoads. And I have a very good reason for this. There's, you know, Phil Spencer's Battletoads shirt, which we've all seen. There's the Battletoads appearance in Shovel Knight, which admittedly was asked for by Yacht Club, but yep. I still think it's kind of hinting at something. And the biggest part is that when Darkseid, the studio that was working on that Phantom Dust game, they originally were talking about working with Microsoft on a project, and they were offered a big number of like IPs they could potentially work on. But one of the ones that they said was off the table was Battletoads. And I have to think, it wouldn't be off the table unless they were already doing something with it.
Interesting. Mm. That's a good big boss prediction.
Again, though, that's just big boss.
Let's get
if we're keepers. Going to Kiefer.
Let's get into them Kiefers.
One, this is the year for Beyond Good and Evil 2. I have to believe.
You aren't the only one, my friend.
Last year, you just didn't believe hard enough.
It's true. It's true. I've doubled down my belief.
I don't believe this.
Number two, this is the year for Golden Sun.
Ooh.
I'd like that.
On 3DS?
Assumedly, yes, because that's always been a portable franchise, so I figure 3DS is the safest bet.
All right, Golden Sun.
Don't worry. If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead by now.
Number three, I think this is the year for Mega Man. Coming fresh off that cartoon announcement, I think we're going to get a very, very short first look at whatever the new Mega Man incarnation is, and it's going to somehow tie in with that animated series that Man of Action is working on.
But I
don't think it's going to be more than maybe like a piece of concept art or a 15-second teaser, because that show isn't supposed to start until like 2017,
yeah.
I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so if it is tied in with the show, it's going to be a while before we see it, but I think they're going to put out something to just say, hey, not dead, for reals, seriously.
Man, hope you're right, believe so in us and give us your money. See some footage of what Capcom's planning to cancel already.
Now, where do we see it?
My gut says Nintendo just because of Smash Brothers, but realistically, I could see it at any one of the console conferences.
Hmm. All right. The return of Mega Man.
I have to finish this.
And the final key for prediction. You guys might be familiar with a little Kickstarter that I've been horribly obsessed with called Youko.
Yeah.
That Kickstarter ends the day after Nintendo's conference, and they said there is a very good reason for why they chose that as the end date.
Oh.
I submit to you, the reason for this is because on at least one of the consoles, they are going to have an exclusive appearance by another character from one of those first-party titles. So, realistically, I don't know if it would all be for them, but realistically, if they had one for each, I'm going to call Banjo on the Xbox version, DK on the Wii U version, and Ratchet on the PS3 version to tie in with the movie, the PS4 version. Wow.
That is a real key for prediction.
I said you're finished! Get out!
That is...
I go big or I go home.
That's right.
Do you just never go home?
I'm kind of a drifter.
That's so sad.
Thank you, Cyberlink, for joining us. Really do appreciate your time.
Oh, it is my pleasure, and...
Good luck to everyone. Have a great E3.
You too, man.
All right, we'll see ya. All right, it's time to talk third parties, and joining us is X the Dark One. Hey, how are you?
Hi. I'm good. Yeah, I'm really good. I've got a bit of Domo's here, ready to chomp away when I'm done.
All right.
Pizza time. Sorry.
So we're going to go with our first question here. We're going to say, will an Elder Scrolls game, now not the Elder Scrolls Online, will it be discussed during Bethesda's conference?
I don't think it will.
Hmm.
Hmm.
I think they're going to be focusing all that. Because I've heard rumors that it's like there's a 40-minute gameplay of Fallout 4 going to be there.
Yeah, it's going to be lengthy. I've heard like half an hour, but that's a long time.
Yeah, I heard it's like 30-40 minutes. So I reckon it's going to be more, it's going to be just focused on Fallout.
Yeah. Yeah, Fallout's the big one. Doom is going to be also really big. Wouldn't surprise me to see Dishonored 2, because Dishonored did well for them, so wouldn't surprise me to see a sequel there. But yeah, they'll mention Elder Scrolls Online. I mean, it would have just come out by that time. It's, you know, in a few days it's on consoles. So
it's free to play now.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Because
no one wants to pay for it.
Yeah. It'll just be, what it'll do is, it'll be like, hey, to all you Elder Scrolls Online players who, you know, who paid from the beginning, this is for you. And it'll be just a picture of, like, the head of Bethesda with a big middle finger just going, hey,
that's kind of like any MMO.
Yeah,
pretty much.
That free-to-play countdown starts.
But see, Elder Scrolls, would they get something regarding, like, I don't know, maybe they say, like, and we're working on 6?
Well, first off, I don't think they're going to do that, no. I think they're going to want nothing to take away from Fallout being the big showing that they're going to have. They don't want anything to take away from it. I don't even think they're going to mention online, simply because they're in this weird position right now of they're skirting in between, yeah, we know it's a failure, and what? We don't know what that is. We didn't make that. We talk about it. It's not even real.
Mm-hmm. No, but it should be very interesting for Bethesda, you know, the first year for them hosting a big conference like that. And yeah, Fallout 4, a big one, you know, a couple days ago from our time of recording, they had the trailer, which was pretty excellent. And I think, you know, at the conference, they'll drop the 2015 hammer and say it's coming this year. But other than that, yeah, I don't see an Elder Scrolls game. And yeah, I said no on this one.
I said yes because I want there to be one. Same. I don't know, probably won't be, but I want there to be.
I'm gonna say no just because it's, you know, it's Fallout. Fallout's the one we've been waiting for ages, so that's the one they're gonna just be like, that's gonna be the main dish.
Yeah.
I know, but forgive me for saying, I prefer Elder Scrolls to Fallout.
I think you're well right in your right mind to say that. I think they've both got elements that they're, you know, I think they're both unique in their own ways.
Just for the fact that once upon a time, Sean Bean was in one, and he still died!
We had 29% of our contest applicants say yes, so not looking too likely there, but we'll be interesting to see Bethesda showing at E3. It'll be on Sunday night, and that's like a 7 p.m. Pacific time, 10 p.m. Eastern. Goodness, like 2 in the morning over there in the UK. That's got to be rough.
Yeah, I shan't be watching it live. Oof. Nope.
That's tough. But Square Enix is also doing a conference. My goodness, it's just the year of conferences. So we ask, will they reveal a release month for Final Fantasy 15 in the United States?
They kind of have to at this point.
Yeah, I think so. They've already got a demo, so it's like...
And an update to the demo.
Give us summit.
I've tried saying this to American people before, and they're like, you what?
American people are dumb.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Summer is something. I totally didn't realize what I'd done there. I do apologize.
That's okay.
I'm going to do the rest of this podcast in Cockney slang.
I hope they do, simply because I need them to be done so that I can get Kingdom Hearts 3 news, because I don't give a shit about Final Fantasy 15.
Oh.
That's a lie. I care a little bit about Final Fantasy 15, but god damn it! Kingdom Hearts 3. I care about that so much more.
I'm going to go a little crazy here. I don't think we'll get a month. I think we will either get a quarter, or screw it, we'll get a day.
Ooh.
But I would love either. I want that game.
Yeah, I think it'll be a quarter. So whether it's something like spring 2016 or something like that, but they're doing an update to the demo. And like they have a release date for that, and maybe they're focusing on that. So gosh, I think several months ago they said it was maybe 55% done. So yeah, I think it's either a specific day or it's a quarter, and I think I'm leaning more towards the quarter. So I'm gonna say no on the release month.
Killing me here, Square.
I think Square Enix's whole conference is just going to be a giant game of Hangman. It's like, okay, give me a letter. If it's in the month, then it's coming out. It will go on the board.
No,
it doesn't get released for a year.
It's going to be like, it's going to spell Final Fantasy VII Remake, but like... I'm trying to figure out a joke with that, but like I can't make jokes about that anymore.
The pieces are all there.
The PC version is also coming to Vita.
Square does it for me.
Ah, shit.
See, I actually said no to this question because I'm so used to them trolling us now. Because fuck Square.
Yeah.
Fuck what happened with Final Fantasy VII. And just awesome. Fuck you.
I'm gonna dance outside the realms of popularity and say, yes, they are going to reveal a month.
All right.
They may reveal a date. Hmm. And a time exactly.
Time exactly. What worldwide? Exactly.
It'll be at 7777.
Oh my god.
43% of people said yes to the month, so that's almost a toss up there. But what about Kingdom Hearts?
One version.
Will new video footage of Kingdom Hearts 3 be shown during the Square Enix conference?
Yeah.
They better.
Mm.
I want to see more than just, hey, we're riding a roller coaster around the Rock Titan. Is this enough for you? By the way, that was 2 years ago.
Now, if they do, what worlds will be shown?
I think Frozen, San Tokyo.
Two right.
Yep.
I'm going to go with more Pirates of the Caribbean.
Here, I actually had the thought the other day that I kind of hope Pirates of the Caribbean comes back, if only because it won't
look... fucking do it!
It won't look as terrible anymore, because in Kingdom Hearts 2, holy shit, that level is the ugliest goddamn... oh my god.
And hopefully they sound much better.
Yeah, hopefully they learn their lesson and they don't sound like they're falling asleep. It'll also be rid of the worst mechanic of the Pirates of the Caribbean world, which is the cursed pirates, because fuck those guys! Mm-hmm.
Yep. I don't think we'll see video footage of Kingdom Hearts 3. And I know that's terrible thing to say. If I had to pick a world, I'd say Toy Story.
But if I had to pick a world, I would say Big Hero 6.
That's not a bad one either. Now, I don't think it's going to be there because I think Square Enix has just so much more to show. Because they're also, publishing partners, so they'll show Just Cause 3. They'll maybe show a new Hitman, maybe. They're definitely also show Rise of the Tomb Raider, because they're with that, in addition to Microsoft.
The last footage we saw was 2 years ago.
I know, but that game is so early in development. I don't think that's even a 2016.
I just want something.
If they throw a 2016 date behind Kingdom Hearts 3, I think that's a big deal.
Yeah.
That'd be
huge.
Like, I'm not asking for a release date, guys. I just want a fucking video, all right? I just want something. I don't care if the video is like Donald Duck dying, because that's what he's going to do most of the game anyways. And or, healing Goofy when you're one combo away from killing Larxene, you son of a bitch! I'm sorry.
Now, video footage, it doesn't mean, trailer. It could just be like, even in a little montage. Like, if we see, new footage, new video of Kingdom Hearts 3, like, that would count.
Stuff we haven't seen before.
Exactly.
That's all I ask. That's all I want.
Now, 90% of people think that we will see something like that, so...
Well, I mean, because Kingdom Hearts 3 is a big deal. Like, yeah. It's a really big deal.
And so. They ought to know that. Let's shift focus to EA, though. Will a new Star Wars game that is not Battlefront be revealed?
Nope.
No. No.
No, I don't think there's going to be, because when Disney came along and they bought Lucasfilms and they had that really good Star Wars game, you know, that we saw footage of, that, what was it,
13-13.
Yeah, and that was looking awesome, and the Star Wars like, well, you know, we're in charge now, so these lot can fuck off. So, no, they're going to do Battlefront, and then they're going to let Star Wars come out, and then next year, when the Rogue One movie comes out, then they're going to release, like, a Rogue One-based game.
Mm.
Which has technically been out since, like, for 20 years.
Right. Now, that'd be interesting, because there is the game that Visceral is working on, that Amy Hennig, the writer of the Uncharted series, is now behind. There is that game that, you know, still has yet to be announced, and I think it's too early now for it. I think, you know, next year we'll see that game from her and that team. But then the other possibility is, well, maybe they just put out, like, a pretty low quality, just in time for the movie. Just a tie-in game.
And I said no, but that's the only thing, the reason I think that there could very well be another game other than Battlefront coming out, being that the movie comes out soon.
Yeah.
We get it's Episode 7 soon.
Yeah, you get the DLC in Battlefront, but that's about it.
At the same time, I feel like right now, Battlefront is the big deal Star Wars game.
Yeah.
So they may just focus on that and try not to let anything take its thunder right now.
Yeah. So, yeah, I say no, but those are the other two possibilities. It's either the Visceral game that Amy Hennig's writing, or it's, you know, they make some shoddy, you know, cross-gen Star Wars Episode 7 movie that ties in the plot, and it's going to be garbage. But those are your options. And so I think that's no. And then, let's see, 38% of people said yes. So it seems pretty unlikely.
Yeah.
Also on the EA front, Mass Effect. Now, it's likely that they'll talk about the next Mass Effect, give a little insight into it. Nothing too in-depth, I don't think, because I think that's a holiday 2016 game, probably. But will they reveal Mass Effect Trilogy Remastered?
I would like them to.
I'm on the fence on that. I think, maybe, potentially.
Hmm.
I'm sorry, what was that noise?
That was the uncertainty donkey.
My favorite character.
I know. Out of all my repertoire, he is the best.
I said yes to this only because I think it's very possible, but I could very well see them not do it. And for all we know, maybe they'll just release the trilogy. It won't be remastered for all we know. I don't know. But, like, a lot of shit's getting remastered right now. And Mass Effect is a pretty big trilogy. Mm-hmm. So it's very possible, I think.
I think it's something they really should do. Especially if you're going to have the next game. If you want the save file from the trilogy to carry over in some capacity. It's, you know, not going to be a Shepard story, sorry. But they've been saying that, you know, ever since they've talked about a new Mass Effect game. It's going to be, you know, a new character. But if they want decisions made in your universe from the first three games, like, you got to have it in some sort of file where it can carry over in that regard.
They can, like, add features, like new stories to the remastered version that kind of does get included in the new Mass Effect games. So it's like something very small that kind of builds up.
That'd be really cool. That'd be really, really cool. I'd like that a lot. Those games, I think, out of all the different games that are, you know, getting these remasters, I think Mass Effect Trilogy is the one that's, you know, begging for it the most. So I think yes.
Because I want it, and I still need to play it, and I just want it.
Ben, you say no, though.
I think it's a next year thing.
Okay.
I think they want to let the end of Mass Effect sit a little bit more, but I'm not the most informed guy when it comes to this sort of thing. I'd like a new one, because I'd like a good chance to play the series for real.
Yeah, I think EA's conference as a whole is going to be really interesting, because last year was all that conceptual footage. So BioWare Montreal has a new IP that they're apparently working on. There's a new IP from Criterion, who did, you know, the Burnout games, and they also did Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. They have Mirror's Edge 2, or if that's going to be the final title, that's coming out in the first quarter of next year, apparently. Of course, they have all their sports games. I wonder how much they'll talk about FIFA after all the different controversies. And pretty sure the sequel that nobody wanted or needed is going to be announced. I think there's going to be Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2.
Garden.
Oh, right. That game was the thing.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. If it's Garden Warfare... Oh, what's a pun for Black Ops? Shit.
Black Crops.
Yeah, Black Ops. Black Ops.
Bad Crops.
Bad Crops.
Oh, jeez.
That's great. So I think that's going to happen. So that should be very interesting. Now, X the Dark One, you have predictions for us.
Oh, yeah, bold prediction. And this might be tipping on crazy, but Skyrim remastered for next gen.
Ooh. I could see that. I could see that. It's a bold prediction, though.
Yeah, I think that is my bold prediction. I think if they... Because Skyrim was one of the most successful games in history, really, next to, you know. And it just makes sense to bring that to next gen.
It's so much DLC, too. Just bundle it all in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then add more.
There you go.
Add more.
That is my bold prediction.
That'd be great. See, I haven't played Skyrim yet, but if it did a remaster, like, I'd get on board with that.
Okay, my crazy prediction, Kingdom Hearts... And again, this is a crazy one, and I was told crazy, Marvel / Star Wars World Kingdom Hearts.
Ooh. Ooh. Now, is that an and or an or?
I'm thinking more towards Marvel.
Mm.
You can so see, like, Sora, like, doing some stuff, and then Iron Man just goes,
Hur-dunk! Yeah.
Marvel summons.
Definitely. Marvel World. Oh, Marvel World and or Star Wars.
And or Star Wars. That is my crazy prediction.
In Kingdom Hearts, wow.
Well, I mean, they have asked the director, like, I think they did an interview with the director when they asked, like, is that a possibility? And he was like, every time I see Disney's bought something, I go to them and ask, hey, can I use that? And he said the answers always vary.
I mean, they added Star Wars and Infinity 3. I think they'd be wanting to get that out there. That's really going. I like that.
Rocky Raccoon summons.
God, no, that'd be awesome.
X, thank you so much for joining us. Really do appreciate the time.
Yes, sir. All right, anytime.
Yeah, have a great E3, man.
I will have a great pizza right now.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thanks again, guys.
It's a shame it's not cheeky Nando's, though.
Ah, yeah. Well, we can afford a cheeky Nando's if I can. We'll do. Take care, guys.
All right, have a good one.
Bye.
All right, let's go on to our next question. But first, we're going to bring in Cadet Hat Sean. How are you, man?
Doing well. How about you guys?
We're doing pretty good. We're talking some third parties here for E3 2015. Let's get right into it. For Ubisoft, will Ubisoft reveal a Rayman, a Splinter Cell, or a Watch Dogs sequel? Yes or no?
I kind of separated this one into three separate ones for each franchise.
Sure.
Rayman, yes. Splinter Cell, no. Watch Dogs, yes.
Hmm, interesting. I think it happens with Watch Dogs, personally. I mean, we had that LinkedIn profile that said it was happening. It's a title that sold really well for Ubisoft, admittedly, and, you know, it wasn't a critical success, but it did really, really well on the sales front, especially for a new IP, so they want to make that, you know, a game that just comes out as often as they can, and, you know, with it focusing on current gen instead of focusing on last gen as well, I think it could have a lot of potential on what they could do with that. I'd love to see another Rayman game, though.
Oh, yeah, totally. Like, I haven't played Legends yet, but I've seen a lot of good stuff about it.
So good.
I would like it to be something exclusive with Nintendo again, since they kind of flaked on that last one.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, wishful thinking, you know?
Yeah.
I've always been kind of the house that Mario built, so.
Right. Reports I hear from the other systems that had Legends, like, with the sections with Murphy, it's not the same. It's meant for that gamepad. But like, it was
tailor-made.
Absolutely, and it's one of the best platformers out there. I really love how fluid it is and how it quickly just gets you right back on the action. So I'd be really happy to see another Rayman. But
yeah, totally.
I think the Watch Dogs chances are definitely higher.
Yeah.
Now, I personally want a Rayman, but I don't want a 2D platformer because they've done 3D platformers before. Mm-hmm. And 3D platformers are on the rise again, sort of. Not kind of. Really, but like... We've got Ukulele, we've got A Hat in Time, we've got Lobo Destroyo. Those are all Kickstarter ones, I know, but 3D platformers are kind of starting to come back. A little bit. And I would like to see a AAA company get behind that. Mm-hmm. Rayman seems to be the only franchise Ubisoft has that they don't feel content with shitting on right now. So
there is that.
You know, they could go with like some sort of like spiritual successor to Hoodlum Havoc or something like that, you know?
Yeah.
I don't think Splinter Cell happens, though. And
no.
Yeah.
Got like another Tom Clancy game for like the third year in a row.
Well, they're already
working. Rainbow Six has got that Tom Clancy Money in the Bank.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're doing two other Tom Clancy games that are supposed to come out either this year or next year.
And then Division, was pushed to 2016. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they're not going to do another Splinter Cell. Nor should they. Since Blacklist was, just hot
so bad.
Garbage.
Mm. Yeah, I've said no to this one as well. I don't think that, one, they'll have the sense to make one of these games good at the moment. I'm being a bit mean, I'm sorry. But I just don't think it's going to happen. I just think people are just going to be like, oh, we know what games are good right now. Nope.
But I think it happens with Watch Dogs. That'd be something to see. And we had 81% of people who participated in the contest say yes for that question. So, interesting. Moving on to the music games. Will Rock Band 4 or Guitar Hero Live be featured with a trailer or demo during a press conference?
I said yes for this one, too, just because the fact that they're both coming out this year. So yes. They got to drum up some hype. No pun intended.
Oh, jeez.
Just don't read into that.
I'd love to see it, but I don't think it's going to happen because the conference time, like, it's precious, and they have so much to fit in there. And I think people know generally what they're getting with Guitar Hero and Rock Band. Yeah, Guitar Hero is a bit different this year with how they're setting up with the guitar and the interactive crowd and all that. But, yeah, I'd love to see it because I'm a big music game junkie. I just don't think that the conference space is the right place for it.
Thinking about it now, it'd probably be like, maybe Rock Band gets some time on PlayStation, Guitar Hero gets some time on Xbox, mm-hmm. as conferences. And, you know, give that sort of like, you know, warring fashion, you know.
I could see it in a montage of like games that are coming out this year, but as far as like a, you know, a section of the show with a trailer or demo, I'm doubting it.
If anything, I could see a trailer, but yeah, I don't think there's going to be a demonstration or anything, because that's just, I agree, like, we all know what Guitar Hero and Rock Band are. It's not like they vary in gameplay very much between titles. If anything, yeah, I think it'll be playable on the show floor somewhere.
I really want a live demo because I just want to see it go wrong. It's the meanest thing I've ever thought, but yeah.
Well, like a Dance Central thing circa 2009, right? Or 2010?
I'm not sure.
Just anytime they try to do anything involving like precision or rhythm or motion of any kind in a game on stage, and it just crashes and burns.
Oh, dude, best example, Wii Music.
Oh, yeah.
And again, game, Wii Music
game
just
of,
sort of...
Best game in 2005.
Wii Music just sort of crashed and burned from being Wii Music, but definitely.
I'm actually put yes, because I kind of want them to show how the hell you feel like you're going to be, like, in front of a live audience by yourself in front of a TV screen. Yeah. I don't get that. I want to see how.
It should be interesting. That's for sure. We had 85.7% of people say that, yes, it will happen during a press conference. So bring on the music games. I'm okay with it. I'm doubting it. Though what I do need, a specific release date for the United States for Persona 5. Will that happen at E3?
I don't think that's going to happen at E3.
Initially I said yes, but I'm kind of leaning towards no now.
That's a TGS thing, I think.
Possibly. I mean, I would just put yes, I hope. That's only because I want it to, not because I feel like it should. It probably won't.
If it does, cool, awesome, I want that. But, like, I don't see them doing it at E3.
Well, here's the thing with TGS. I mean, that's getting close to November.
I just mean, like, TGS, when I say that's a TGS thing, I just mean, like, if it would happen at a big conference, it would happen at TGS, not E3. But it could very well just be, like, all the trailers we've gotten so far, which were just, hi, we're releasing this today, take it.
Yeah, because if it's supposed to be a 2015 game, like, Atlas USA still maintains, at least for the United States, which I could easily see it getting delayed. But if they still are going to maintain that, I think we need to see a release date, or at least nail down a month. But I think at this point it needs to be a release date. TGS, I think, would be like a huge info dump.
Yeah.
I think, like, more on the plot and main characters and whatnot.
Yeah.
For both Japan and the U.S., it's stated for Q4.
Yeah.
Pretty close to release date.
Yeah, I'm hoping it sticks to that, because that's a game I want this year really badly.
Yeah. I put yes.
And we have 38.1% of people say yes. So I don't know if everyone else is doubting it, but it might be the specific release date part. It's a tough thing to nail down a specific date on games like that. Will a new game from Rockstar be revealed?
Probably not.
No.
I think they're still kind of riding off the high of GTA 5.
Mm-hmm.
People are still playing
it. On Steam.
They just finished PC. They just finished... They just finished the PS4 version, so I don't think.
Yeah, PS Quad just came out.
I don't think they do a new game. I think they do story DLC for Grand Theft Auto 5.
Like Lost and the Damned?
Yeah, something like that. So I think we get story DLC like that. Maybe they bring in CJ a little more from San Andreas. I don't know. Make it at least initially exclusive on PlayStation 4, since they have the marketing tie-in there. I think, if anything, that's what they show at E3, because it'd be like a console-specific thing. As much as I'd like to say, like, oh, do another Red Dead game, or, hey, how about that game Agent? Like, it's not really the place for that thing. And plus, Rockstar usually isn't a big, you know, E3 presence.
Yeah, they're not usually.
I put yes, but I think it is more of a remake or remaster. I guess we're calling them remasters now. I think it's going to be more along that lines of like an older one. Maybe Bully. I don't know.
Maybe Bully. That'd be interesting.
Maybe make Bully better. The dork inside of me really wants a remake of Warriors. So I like that movie.
That'd be interesting.
I mean, they won't. There's no chance. But I put yes.
We had 19% say yes. So, Ben, you're among that 19%.
Not surprised.
You did.
Will a new game be revealed in a series where its last game was released over 10 years ago?
Now, does it have to be a third party?
Doesn't.
Or can it be anybody?
It can be anybody.
As Dark pointed out the other day, F-Zero now applies for this.
Interesting. Now, we had Zombie U apply for it one of the years.
Yes.
So it does apply for any game at all. It doesn't have to be only third party.
I've put down yes, but I don't have anything to back up what exactly it should be. Because I just want them to.
Yeah.
I guess. My yeses and noes have been pretty fucking flimsy tonight. I do apologize.
I put no because I can't even imagine what that could possibly be anymore. We've rebooted and remade everything possible at this point.
I think we're just focusing on, you know, some of these games, and I'm just not sure what it would be. Even if they did something like a Prince of Persia, I mean, that was less, 2009?
Yeah.
So that's not even, it's like 6 years. Not even close to 10. Sean, what do you think?
I'm a bit of an optimist, so I'm going to say yes.
Okay.
I'm a wishful thinker. Maybe this is part of my sort of Hail Mary full of grace prediction. Maybe another Beautiful Joe?
Ooh.
I would like that. Just finish the trilogy.
That'd be really cool.
I've been waiting for so long.
But he's been in all the fighting games.
Yeah.
So, like, that's the worst part, though. He's been in all the fighting games, so you know they haven't forgotten about him. They're just not making a game.
I'm like, oh, hey, guys, can I get my game now? Actually, Joe, we're going to start Jones and Street Fighter stuff. You want to be in this Marvel vs. Capcom game and this Tatsunoko game? I'm like, but...
Okay, but after that, do I get my game? I don't know.
Well, I mean, you got your DS game a while back. That was years ago. Can I just finish my story?
You know, Beautiful Joe.
this one for
some
that.
Some might say you're being a little ungrateful. Do you want to end up like Mega Man?
They have the bat in the hand.
It's like the shot of Joe's face up close, just like the cold sweat, just like...
That's probably exactly what happened.
We have 52.4% of people say yes, that this kind of reboot game release will happen. So that's a toss-up. Sean, thank you for joining us. Do you have your predictions for us?
Well, I kind of just said it, so yeah. Beautiful Joe.
Beautiful Joe.
Either that or with how Splatoon's been going, maybe a remake of Sunshine.
Ooh.
Kind of like Wind Waker HD.
Yeah, Sunshine HD, I'd like that. That'd be great.
Either that or, like, maybe not immediately, but I know a lot of people have been saying about, like, a Al Delfino map for Splatoon.
Yeah, we've heard that one a couple times. That's a popular one. I mean, are you digging Splatoon?
Yeah, I've been playing it for a while, and yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was pretty fun.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, Sean, thank you for joining us. Really do appreciate your time, and have a great E3.
You too. And thanks for having me.
Yeah.
And I will bid you all adieu.
All right, see ya.
Good route. Right.
Bye.
All right, last part of the show here. This is our section where we say, is this the year for a reveal of? And we have a list of games that, you know, where has this game been? Will this be the year we hear more info about it? So joining us is KindKing01. How are you, Ken?
Good. How are you today?
We're doing fine. We're going to have you here for five of these games. So let's start with, I don't know, is this the year for the reveal of Fallout 4?
No. No, definitely not.
No, not at all.
No. Not seen that game for years.
Yeah. It's not at all that the trailer's already been out there.
Look, guys, that game is never going to happen. Just give up. Sit down in the corner.
It was a joke, okay? It was a very, very late April Fool's joke, so leave it alone.
In June.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you think of the trailer, though, that already has come out?
I'm happy that it's out, but I was a little underwhelmed by the graphics. Like, compared to, like, The Witcher that's out right now, the textures look a little bit flat, especially the hair models.
Yeah, I mean, Bethesda isn't really a studio that really amps up the graphics, though. As long as it plays well, and I'm sure we'll see a long demo during Bethesda's conference, so I think that'll be really the test of it. But the game is likely going to be coming out in 2015, and that's exciting.
Yeah, definitely.
As long as it comes out on PC, people will make better graphics for it.
That's
a Bethesda.
Well, considering that it's already been available for pre-order.
Mm-hmm.
There's that.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, that's certainly going to happen. Now, what about Banjo 3E?
Nope!
I said no as well on this one.
Yeah.
It would be interesting if it came out. It'd kind of be like Banjo 3 versus Ukulele. Not like a Rocky IV situation.
Almost. It'd be like Microsoft saying, like, well, we think we know better.
Yeah, definitely not.
They're going to look at nuts and bolts. They're going to say, well, we tried it once, and it didn't work.
No one's going to want to go for a Banjo 3 unless they can show that they've got their shit back together and gone, hey, guys, we made a platformer now. There's no cars.
That would require them to use Rare for something, and they don't do that.
Cars are DLC!
Just in case you liked that. I think Ukulele is where it is at, and like I don't think they want to necessarily compete with that. It would look bad if they did something like that.
It'd be funny.
It would be funny. I'll give it that. We had 90.5% of people say yes for Fallout 4, justifiably so.
Who said no?
I would assume
some people before the game got announced.
Some people trying to make some bold predictions that it wouldn't happen. But then 9.5% of people say yes for Banjo 3E. So
those are some sad bastards right there.
Yep. Now, 6 years later, Ken, is this the year for The Last Guardian?
No.
Oh, God, I hope so.
No.
Yes.
It's been killed so many times in theory that I feel like they have to finally show something this year.
But Sony keeps saying they're working on it.
Exactly.
Shuhei Yoshida is like, they were working on it at Japan Studio. I'm just amazed that Team Eco is still alive, since what have they done to make money? But
remastered.
Exactly. That's really it. But I think it comes back this year. Though I'm not sure it'll be under the Last Guardian name.
Really?
It wouldn't surprise me if it kind of gets re-revealed with a different title. People will know that it's that game. I'm sure, like, the Griffin will appear and whatnot. But just to get that name, like, kind of out of the infamy.
Shadow of the Colossus 2.
Yeah.
I hope it's a gritty reboot, and I hope it's a first-person shooter.
Is it basically going, if it's Shadow of the Colossus 2, is it going to be the story of the horse that died?
Agro, no! Just don't shoot the griffin, please.
Oh, God.
That'd be so sad. Oh, that's going to be the Metal Gear Solid 3 ending. God damn it! No!
We're going to be forced. One of them's going
to
die.
I know. We're going to be forced to do it.
Oh, my God.
No! But no, I think it's got to be the year. It's got to be. We say that every year, but it's got to be, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
We say that every year that gets me. No, yeah. It's not.
Ben and I say yes, and we're among the 43% of contest entrants who said yes. So
you sad, sad people.
Never give up faith.
Yeah, never surrender.
What about Metroid on either Wii U or 3DS?
Nope.
No.
Just the fact that Star Fox is going to be their big push this year. They don't want two space games, I think.
Oh, that's a good point. Oh, God. Remember the old retro rumor of Star Fox crossover with Metroid?
Oh, my God.
See, that's why I've put yes.
Oh.
So I want them to cross it over so they get both Star Fox and Metroid out this year. So I've put yes.
Interesting. Which would you prefer? Wrong,
but I've done it anyway.
Which would you prefer?
Metroid, actually.
Well, the Wii U or 3DS?
Oh, gosh. I'm more of a fan of using the 3DS, actually.
Mm-hmm.
But I think because they've already put Star Fox 64 onto there,
yeah,
I would go with Wii U.
Huh. Yeah, I was saying, if it was 3DS, like, Metroid Prime on 3DS does not count. So, yeah, gotta be a new Metroid. Yeah, I said no. I think it comes back to retro, and, like, would they go back to doing that? I don't think so. But 57% of people say yes, so the Nintendo hype is real, I guess. And finally, Resident Evil 7 here for you, Ken.
I said no to this one as well.
Yeah.
No.
They just released Revelations 2. Everybody hated Resident Evil 6. They're not going to make Resident Evil 7.
I've literally answered this as, please God, no, in all caps.
Yeah. They're making Resident Evil 0 HD. I think if they... Yeah, they have announced that. I think if they do come back to Resident Evil, it's going to be, like, a reboot. To try to, like, get back to... They're seeing how successful the original HD was.
I'd like HD remakes of 2 and 3. Mm-hmm. Because I've heard 2 and 3 are very good.
I'm sure they'll get to it.
Oh, 2 and 3!
Here's the thing. People have been waiting for remake-style versions of 2 and 3 since the original Resident Evil remake for the GameCube came out, and it never happened. But I want to experience Nemesis, because I've never had a way to experience Nemesis.
Hmm. Yeah, I'm sure they'll eventually do it. I mean, it's part of Capcom's business model that they saw how successful some of these HD remakes are, and they're like, well, we'll just do that, because why else would you make Devil May Cry 4 Special Edition a thing? Because you like doing HD remakes and you like making money off of it. So I could see that happening, but a Resident Evil 7, yeah, you could say what you want about a 3-year cycle since the last one, but I don't think it's happening.
Yeah.
We had 14.3% of people say that it would happen, so it seems pretty unlikely. So Ken, we'll let you go, but first, your big boss and key for predictions.
All right. For a big boss, it refers to Animal Crossing for the Wii U. Mm-hmm. I do believe that it's coming out. It's going to have fully integrated amiibo support. And I think the way they're going to do it is they're going to have actual amiibo, like the actual little statuettes, where you can like unlock items in your town. But also the Animal Crossing trading cards that are coming out for the Happy Home Academy. There'll be a specialized amiibo house in the game where you can scan one card in and have that. Like it's almost like a guaranteed villager in that house.
Hmm. Expanded amiibo support in Animal Crossing for Wii U. Big boss.
And Kiefer, because we know the Binding of Isaac Rebirth is coming to Wii U and 3DS,
that's right.
Ed McMillan will work with Nintendo to make Isaac amiibos.
Oh, interesting.
That is a very interesting one, actually.
I would love like all the main characters, just amiibos of them.
A Binding of Isaac amiibo line. That's Kiefer.
I need help!
Thank you, thank you.
All right, KindKing01, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Hope you have a great E3, man.
You too, guys.
All right, yeah, take care. Good talk.
See ya.
Yep. Bye. And joining us for the last bit to round it all off, it is Major Moses.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, hey.
It's good to be here. It's been a while.
It has been a while, but let's finish off these last five games. Is this the year for a reveal of Left 4 Dead 3? Can Valve count to three?
Nope. I said no. That's because they're going to be revealing three.
Three?
Valve 3. It's just going to be three.
Just Valve 3.
No, it's going to be three. It's going to be Left 4 Dead 3, Portal 3, and Half-Life 3.
Why?
Let's do it.
And all on the HTC Vive, their VR headset.
Yes.
But only on that.
Yes, exclusive.
Now, if that were to happen, would that count as a yes or a no for that?
Would it count as a yes?
What? But it's not Left 4 Dead 3.
Left 4 Dead 3 would be part of it. You just said that.
Yeah, you just said it.
No. I mean, it's all one game.
Wait, what?
I'm confused.
Basically getting there's all zombies. Of the number three games and putting them into one big game.
Yeah, no. There's zombies, there's Gordon Freeman, and there's the portal gun.
Just call
it
three.
It makes sense.
God, I would play the shit out of that game. Oh my God.
I think just for the craziness, I think that would count.
I'm hoping that doesn't happen.
Yeah, otherwise, I said no. Yeah, say what you will about, Source 2 that's out there. There is the Valve board that someone took a picture of saying that Left 4 Dead 3 is being worked on, so it's possible. I think out of some of the unlikely ones here, this has a good chance, but I don't think it's going to happen.
But there's also one problem with anybody saying yes. They forget. Valve doesn't make video games anymore.
They also don't care about E3, so...
That is also a thing. They don't really give a shit about E3.
It's all about multiplayer.
They've announced games at E3. Like, they announced Left 4 Dead at E3, and they announced Portal 2. Well,
that was an announcement
for PlayStation
right at
E3, but that was just an excuse for Gabe Newell to go up and sarcastically talk about how good he thought consoles were. That was amazing, by the way.
Hmm. Yeah, so we had 23.8% of people say yes. Ben, you were among them.
Wasn't there some sort of email leak?
Yeah, it was something like that, and someone took a picture of a board in Valve headquarters that had something on there.
I hadn't heard about the board. It was mostly just, I really want Left 4 Dead 3. Mm. I put 500 hours into the first one. About 300 into the second one.
Jeez, that's like Rachel Binding of Isaac territory.
Mm.
That doesn't really touch my Binding of Isaac hours territory. Sorry. Oh. Nearly, though.
I bow down. But yeah, I'd love a third one.
It'll be interesting to see what they even do for that PC conference, because, I mean, what is there for that?
Yeah.
It'd be strange, though, to have Valve not present there.
That's true, and I think they will be present. So
I feel like there will be something to do with Steam.
Steam
they'll
machines?
They'll be present, but they won't talk about... I don't think it'll be Steam machines, because those are closer to consoles.
Hmm. But they'll pretend they're not at E3, because they don't like it.
I don't think they're going to be going to announce any type of game or anything. It's just all going to be new stuff coming to Steam.
And their controller.
Steam controller. You can already buy Steam controllers.
Right.
You don't get them yet, but you can order them. The new Steam refund stuff. Windows 10 we were talking about a lot.
Yep.
You know, the controller will probably be out on the floor. I'm sure Valve will want to have their new controller tested out on the floor and get the word out.
Certainly. Yeah. Now the next one is Shenmue HD.
No.
I don't care.
Hey, mister.
Pretty sure Shenmue HD needs to stop being on this list.
It's like the first year it's on its list.
I said yes. Just saying.
I
played Shenmue.
This game is not happening ever.
I said no.
I think it could happen. So I'm sort of in Rachel's corner. Like, I almost put yes.
I did put yes.
We had 9.5% of people put yes. And the reason is Yu Suzuki, who is the creator of Shenmue, was basically radio silent on Twitter for about 2 years. And a couple weeks ago, he starts tweeting again. he's now favoriting things with the hashtag of, you know, save Shenmue. Would not surprise me if part of PlayStation's Building the List campaign, if they bring a Shenmue HD collection. Not a Shenmue 3, because that's not going to happen, unfortunately. But it would not surprise me if they bring something like that to PlayStation.
I'm just going to, like, just get this out of the way real quick. I was very pessimistic for this part. The only thing I said yes for was the game that's already announced. So...
Well, last year was a really good year for knocking a lot of those out. I mean, you know, like Battlefront and all that.
But it was obvious that was going to be.
See, I'm kind of the opposite. I don't think they'll do an HD Shenmue. But if the thing on the list said 3, I think I'd put yes.
Interesting.
They were slated to make it. Like a couple years ago. It was like, yeah, they're probably going to let me make it if we can just find the money for it. Cause, like,
what if they just tossed it on the Vita? Wasn't HD.
Yeah, I could see that. Possible. I could see that. It's an old game. There's a whole new audience for it. But I don't know.
What about Crash Bandicoot?
No. I don't see how they could bring him back into the current climate just with the way that they've changed him. Like, I couldn't see it happening now.
Yeah.
I feel like give it a few more years and maybe it'll be a good time for a reboot. I know it's been a long time already, but...
They've dropped those hints. I mean, whether it's in a PlayStation commercial and he's there on a sign, there are things floating around the internet that say, like, it's possible. But I don't think it happens this year.
Mm. I don't know who would take it. Because the developer, like, that's, like, the most changed hands.
Yeah.
Game series.
Doesn't Activision own them right now?
I don't think they do anymore.
Did they not?
Good.
No, it's Activision since 2008. Yeah. I'm looking at this. But that's the publisher. That's not the developer.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it could go to any developer. But
and I don't like any of these on the list that have touched it. Like, I know Naughty Dog's not going to take it back. They're way too busy.
Yeah. Making good games. I mean, what?
I don't know. I don't think so.
No. This is the lowest one on the list. 4.8% of people said yes.
Just trying to get that upset.
Mm-hmm. But what about Beyond Good and Evil 2? We already had a big boss prediction saying that it would be revealed.
While I said no, a lot of people seem to think this is the year for it.
Yeah, 23.8% of people saying yeah. I said yes last year, but I think that burned me, and so I'm saying no this year. For that footage that looked a lot like Uncharted, like, I want that. But I don't think it's going to happen.
I put no, but I feel like this is the answer that I might have gotten wrong. It could happen.
It'd be great. I think with Ubisoft's plan of wanting to, you know, annualize series, I don't think this is one they revisit.
Yeah. If you look at the three different Ubisofts that were involved with it, they haven't done anything different than just Assassin's Creed and Just Dance in, like, 5 years.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really hard to do.
And, like, the last thing... Aisha Taylor talk about it.
Oh, she's going to be back. Aisha's going to be back talking to Ubisoft. Yes.
Love her.
Girl would.
I don't know. We haven't heard anything about this game since, like, 2008, though.
Mm-hmm. And so I think Michelle Ancel is busy with Wild on PlayStation. So, I don't think it's happening. And finally... Parappa the Rapper.
No. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. See, I want it. Like, by all means, prove me wrong. I want it, but no.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to, but no.
I agree.
Yes. This is definitely happening.
Oh.
No, it's going to happen.
It's going to be on the Vita. This is going to be their big app.
While it's going to be a legacy system, you throw a legacy game on there?
Sure.
Parappa feels too risky for them to attempt right now because the AAA development's very scared shitless of taking a step outside. We know this will make money, so just make it. But, like, Parappa's cute and all that. Now, here's the thing, though. If a new Parappa game does come out, there is one studio that Sony has that would do very well with it because they already make cute games that appeal to everybody. Mini Molecule.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I thought you were going to talk about whatever studio does the Hatsune Miku games.
No,
that's not PlayStation, that's Sega.
No, I don't see why they wouldn't give it to Nanaonsha, or however you pronounce that. Because they haven't done anything since 2012, but they're still around. I'm on their website. Parappa is like the first listed thing on their projects, like stuff they've done.
So maybe
I think this is the year.
What about Jammer Labby?
that's also on there.
I would love for that to come out as well.
Mm-hmm.
I really would.
Well, 14.3% of people said yes. Major Moses, we're gonna let you go, but how about your Big Boss prediction and Kiefer prediction?
So Big Boss prediction. Nintendo invites the six gods of Melee. Mango, Armada, PP, Mewtwo King, HBox, and Borp to give fan opinions of what they think is a new game for Wii. What?
Borp?
Yeah, he's a god of Melee.
Is he?
No.
I thought he's a Pittsburgh guy. I know you're trying to give your Pittsburgh guys rep. I thought you were going to include Leffen in there. I'm like, that's debatable.
Anyway, so Nintendo invites all those guys to give fan opinions of what they think is a new game for Wii U. Okay. We get a hidden camera view of them in a small meeting room that looks fairly similar to the one from the GoldenEye remake teaser. So they start asking questions. What do you look for in a competitive fighting game? What gets you hype? What does Melee mean to you? After Mewtwo King says everything, the camera pans over their excited faces. The interviewer asks, what if I told you that we are making Melee mode for Smash on Wii U and 3DS? And all of them except MTK say, I'd rather just play Melee.
Well, that's your big boss.
You're just making me sad, dude.
Well, let's hear your Kiefer.
Yeah, it's Melee mode for Smash on Wii U and 3DS. For the Kiefer prediction, Nintendo rewards Show Me Your News for their years of hype machine service by making us the official Nintendo podcast.
Damn right.
I thought I'd paid my dues!
This has been the saddest moments of my life. you have broken my heart.
Oh.
Those are my dreams.
We don't want that Dova and Bang guy.
I was like, Reggie's like, we don't want to forget about Read the Manual.
And Iwata just comes out and he's like, so we own this podcast, right? Well, yeah, now we do. All right, you two, you're fired. Just
like, directly to the trash.
We're just like, well, yeah.
It's like, yeah, we saw it coming. We just like shake Iwata's hand and walk off stage. nobody hears from us again for years.
Oh, boy. Well, Major Moses, thank you for joining us. Do appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. I can't wait for this to happen.
Yeah.
I'm hoping it to be a guest.
Predictions. So much fun.
No, we're going to forget all of our friends. We're like going to be those people. Everybody's like, I'm not going to forget where I came from. We're going to forget where we came from.
Have a great E3, man.
As fast as possible.
No problem.
All right, let's wrap up the show, and we're bringing in Solid Snake 120. How are you, Scott?
Oh, not too bad. How about you guys?
Pretty good. You're going to be joining Sword Hunter and myself for E3. We're going to be doing streaming if Twitch decides to work this year. We're going to be doing our reactions, our before and afters. We're going to try to do video coverage from last year, but try to amp it up that little more.
You know what? What? This will be, what, the fifth year?
Oh my gosh, it's either like the fourth or fifth year that we've done something like this with the yes or no questions and all of this stuff. It's really amazing, and it's a big effort. So I want to bring Sword Hunter in as well. Just really putting it all together with all the different guests. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mark.
It's always interesting.
Mm-hmm.
That's a word for it.
That is a word for it, especially this year. So let's wrap up. Maybe the question for the tiebreaker for our yes or no contest is, how many times will the word Mario be mentioned in the Nintendo Digital Event? You know, the average was 42.7. I said 32. Rachel said 47. Joe said 14. And Ben said 227.
I feel good about this one.
That's a safe bet. I think that's a safe bet.
Mario Maker.
I imagine in your mind, it's just like there's a scenario where Iwata just gets on and just starts saying Mario, 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 Mario.
I mean, Mario Maker.
That's all I hear. I mean, oh, I'm
excited for Mario Maker. That should be a pretty exciting game.
You'll never understand.
But let's talk about our big boss and Kiefer predictions. Scott, I'm going to start with you.
For my big boss, I think, I don't know if this has already been discussed, but I think for big boss, we're going to get an announcement of card form of amiibos.
Mm-hmm.
And I think how they're going to do it is they are going to release game-based packs.
Oh.
And by that, I mean you will have like a codenamed Steam pack, which will come with all the amiibo cards that will work specifically with codenamed Steam. And you'll have packs with like Smash Brothers that will release like part of a wave. It'll be like card pack one, wave one or something. And it'll be only cards that work for that. The new Animal Crossing, there'll be a pack for that. And so on and so forth. So I think that's how they're going to do the card-based amiibo thing. So.
Amiibo card packs for games. Game-themed card packs. What about your Kiefer there?
My Kiefer, I think we're going to get a Sly Cooper 5 announcement.
Well, got to change my Kiefer.
That's a good one, though.
This is the last chance you've got to talk to me before I have to hurt you.
I love me some Sly Cooper. I mean, there's that movie coming out. I'm hoping it's not a movie tie-in. They hinted at a Sly 5 at the end of 4, so...
Egypt.
Who knows? Is Sly his own ancestor? Who knows?
Whoa.
He's his own granddaddy.
What about you, Sword Hunter?
For my big boss, Thunder was stolen a little bit, but I think I'm going to be a little bit more realistic and just say Half-Life 3.
It's happening.
It's never going to happen.
I know it's never going to happen, but I'm kind of hoping.
Big boss.
And for my Kiefer, it's something that I don't want to happen, but, you know, God help us if it does. The Nintendo NX is going to be announced with its true name, the new Wii U.
God damn it.
Ooh.
Why are you lying to me?
Oh, those would be something.
Fanboys would cry.
Yeah, no. It would be justified.
And Xenoblade's going to come for exclusively for the new Wii U.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Holy shit, a horse won the Triple Crown.
Oh, yeah, I was going to point that out when the podcast is over, but okay, we can do it now.
Horses!
Yeah.
What?
American Pharoah did win, because I totally forgot that was happening today.
So did I.
Wow. And a new Tales game was announced for Tales fans, which I don't know how many of them are there in the forums, but new Tales game.
Yeah. Big boss. It is going to be a new game from one of Rare's old franchises. In 2012, the company Eurocom went under, laid off its entire staff, and they were the ones who kept making James Bond games, and they were garbage.
Mm.
And I think they're going to bring back kind of the GoldenEye sort of, I'm going to call it a franchise, but because Skyfall and Spectre are getting, Skyfall was a great movie, a lot of traffic, and Spectre's getting a lot of talk, I think we're going to get a new James Bond game from Rare.
Yeah, with Spectre coming out, that'd be pretty awesome. That's a big boss.
I would love that. Kiefer, Last Guardian 2015 release.
Bam.
Don't you ever come into my office and talk to me like that again. Do you understand me?
It's happening. I don't even care anymore. I don't feel anything anymore.
Pretty great. How about you, Joe?
My big boss prediction is Mother 3 is coming to America on Wii U.
Someone had to make it.
An official translation from the Treehouse and everything. Finally coming to Wii U. Finally getting a localization. Maybe on 3DS 2. I don't know. But we're finally getting it after all these years.
I mean, the Earthbound love, the Lucas DLC.
DLC, Earthbound had a really nice reception when it came over here. They mentioned Mother 3 last year at E3
exactly.
as a joke.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I think this is the year. I think this is what we're getting.
Next year.
Do you think it'll be a virtual console release, or are you thinking it will be like an actual like Wii U?
I think it's going to be virtual console, like Sin and Punishment style. Cool. Personally.
Probably a GBA release. Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah. My Kiefer is going to get some people killed if it happens. being that I think there are more amiibo coming. Not just one, not just 10, 649 of them. All 649 Pokemon. Because, as we pointed out earlier, we've discovered that their NFC tags do contain their Pokemon Dex numbers. I think they're going to come out with an amiibo for every Pokemon. Like in packs, to include the evolutionary lines. Maybe the evolutionary lines as one amiibo. But I think that's it. That's my Kiefer.
You think it's going to be the cards, though?
No, no. I have full figures.
Oh, God.
See, I say people are going to die.
My God. Peter, don't buy them all.
Nintendo would get all the monies.
People are going to die, and I'm going to buy 15 Snorlax amiibos.
That'd be pretty Kiefer.
No, I'm not okay.
That is how World War III is going to start. Trying
not
to
with
find
a bang,
all the Pokemon
but
amiibos.
With a Whismur.
That was the best. So, we all know that Five Nights at Freddy's is coming out in October, end of October.
The final chapter.
And I think, for my big boss, that there's going to be a Five Nights at Freddy's anthology coming as a console exclusive to PlayStation 4, which includes all the Five Nights at Freddy's games, including the upcoming sequel.
That's a big boss. I mean, that's indie. That's building the list.
That is one, but I actually have a couple Kiefers.
Oh.
Okay, so one of them is actually regarding what we were talking about earlier, like games getting remade for either Wii U or 3DS. Now, we've already had Super Mario Sunshine. I'm going to go with the one I think will happen more is The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess with 3DS.
You cannot have a normal life and do this job at the same time.
I actually do want to play that. That would be quite good.
Definitely.
My next Kiefer, I think that there are going to be ukulele amiibos.
Ukulele amiibo.
Ukulele amiibo.
That'd be great.
If I told you there's nothing I can do!
Okay. For Nintendo, for Microsoft, and for Sony, I have a big boss and a Kiefer to wrap up the show.
Jesus.
Let's start with Microsoft for big boss. With the Windows 10 functionality, the dashboard on Xbox One will be redesigned to better format this, and it removes the TV functionality.
Ooh.
The Kiefer for Microsoft. We had Cyberlink 420 mention a Mega Man reboot. I think that's happening, but Microsoft is buying the exclusive rights for the game.
Rebecca, what have you done? What have you done?
Because they need something.
That's true.
They need
that would make me so sad.
I know. But that's why it's a Kiefer prediction.
I wouldn't get to play it. I've never bought their consoles.
Yeah. For Sony, after Batman Arkham Knight comes out, Warner Brothers has a partnership with PlayStation 4 to develop a Suicide Squad game. And for the Kiefer, PlayStation versus Capcom.
There are things in this world that are just out of our control.
That ain't happening, buddy.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, after Street Fighter V, after Sony paying the money for that, they're like, hey, let's get together with Capcom and make PlayStation versus Capcom. I mean, they're not going to make a Battle Royale 2.
Considering PlayStation had to pull in a bunch of other third-party characters in for Battle Royale, I don't think they have enough characters to make that roster.
Well, we'll see with that prediction. Now for Nintendo. For Big Boss, The Great Ace Attorney is coming to the United States on September 15th, 2015.
Woohoo. What's special about that date?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just picking a date just to be specific. But it's the ancestor Phoenix Wright game with Sherlock Holmes and Watson, who's a young girl.
Watson John.
Yep. Watson John. And for the Kiefer, we've all heard talk that Zelda Wii U is not going to be at E3, but it is going to be at the Nintendo Direct. We're going to get a title and a story trailer. It just won't be on the show floor.
Break your other wrist.
I've seen a lot of people think that's probably going to be the case, because like, not at E3 usually just means not playable on the show floor.
Mm-hmm. I think it's just a misinterpretation of phrasing. So those are our predictions. That is our pre-E3 show with our predictions. It's a beefy one, I know, but it is every year, and it's certainly a lot of fun with the 50 E3 yes or no questions. So thank you everyone for your help. But Scott, it's going to be fun to have you over, and we'll have some good video content for everyone.
Oh, it's going to be a marathon. So, man.
Sorry I couldn't be there for it.
I know, I so
you were expecting
you
me to as well. Damn it, government!
Seriously. Oh.
In a hilarious thing, it would be pretty hilarious to hire a stripper to just sit there and watch video games. Not to necessarily strip, but just to sit there and be like, we're watching video game press conferences.
So do you guys want us to do, do you guys want me to do anything? Or no, Nintendo's, Reggie is talking right now, sit down.
Like, yeah, no, of course. Pass the popcorn.
What kind of hell is this?
What are your thoughts on the conference so far?
Are you more Sony or are you more Microsoft?
Your answer depends on how well you're getting tipped tonight.
It's true.
Well, on that bombshell, it's time to wrap up the show. With that, I'm Peter.
I'm Rachel.
I'm Drew.
I'm Ben.
I'm Mark.
I'm Snake.
All right. That's everybody. We're out. Thank you for listening. Have a great E3.
Find out more about this show and other podcasts at the Show Me Your News Network, where you can embrace your inner nerd, over at showmeyournews.com. Fans can interact with other sminjas at the friendliest community on the net at showmeyournews.com/forum.
Show Me Your News!